an empire builder. Let us know that that's who you are. That's what you represent. That's what you believe. That's what you're building for your family. Because, you know, we need more empire builders in our community. And I think that we set the standard too low. And this is designed to help you to grow into what you know you can do, what you know you can become. And we're here to support you in that in the Black Business School and with Freedom School, where Julian does his thing as well. So without further ado, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and start my part of the conversation so we can kind of munch away on that. And then we can evolve ourselves into the next element of the discussion. I'm not here to do all the talking. You guys hear from me all the time. I am here to support and to basically tell you guys that I think Julian is one of the brightest young brothers out here, and he's really doing a great work for the community. And I really believe that he is going to transform your life, and that's why I trust him. You know, with your ears, I know that, and your trust is not something we take for granted. It's something that we value. And so anyway, let me hop into this. Let me go ahead and share my slides real quick so we can talk about this. Okay, so emancipation equation. The emancipation equation is basically built on the idea of living free and building Black wealth through real estate. And that's, you know, that's sort of the initial slide there. And you know, you guys know who I am. There isn't much to say about me. The Black Wealth Bootcamp, the Black Business School, 48-hour business school, all these things that we put together. We put these together to be low-cost, high-quality, culturally relevant alternatives to a traditional college education. Why? Well, because when you're trying to solve the problem of Black wealth, you must solve the problem of Black student loans, the problem of Black miseducation, you know, things like that. So that's the first problem that we decided to address. The one thing that kind of changed everything was financial education. You know, when I was able to really dig in and focus on financial education, we were teaching that to the community. It turned out that that was the thing that really sparked a lot of light with a lot of people. I'm in Atlanta right now. We're doing seminars in Atlanta, and we have found that in Atlanta, the conversation is very vibrant around Black ownership, even amongst the rappers and everybody else. We want to own supply chains from mine to money to multifamily real estate, manufacturing to market, no longer relying on other cultures to hand out jobs. So the Jay-Z Colin Kaepernick conversation is not interesting to me because I'm tired of seeing Black people fighting for a limited number of seats. We are not beggars. We are not borrowers. They don't get to pick which Negro is going to succeed and which one's going to fail because we're not trying to get a seat at the table. We want to own the whole damn table. This information has allowed me to be free and to educate a lot of people in the Black Business School. We have over 80,000 students, a lot of people that work for us. We are able to reach 1 million Black people a week without asking for anybody's permission, without going through the FCC or anybody else. And, you know, so we're doing this all over the world. I'm doing it in Atlanta right now. And it's amazing. Also, the Black Business School, we teach a lot of paths to freedom. The biggest thing that we can teach you is how to be free and how to be happy. We're not trying to convince you that you want to be a trillionaire. We're not trying to convince you that you want to go out and buy a Bentley. We're not trying to convince you that money is the most important thing in the world. We just want to convince you to be happy and to be free. If you believe in being happy and free, then we're for you. So if that's who you are, then just say, yes, I want to be happy. I want to be free. One or the other. Pick which one matters to you the most, or maybe they both matter the same to you. But that's what we're here to do. If you're not in favor of your own plan for success, then we don't support that either. We only support the plans that work for you. Now, what we did was we listened to you. We sent out surveys, and we basically found that the top topics that people want to learn about are stock market investing, real estate, entrepreneurship, et cetera, and cryptocurrency. And we laid out the top frustrations. This came from data from you guys. A lot of you don't feel you have the time. We procrastinate. We all do that. Lack of money, lack of access to capital. We've solved that problem. Lack of knowledge and mentorship. We've solved that problem. Fear and self-doubt. We've solved that problem. And so the Black Business School was built for you, by you, supported by you. And we've got experts that can help you achieve that goal. So my first experience with real estate, you know, one of my major experiences was with my grandparents, Matt and Alma. There they are way back in the day, looking very, very handsome. They're a very handsome couple. They were the first Black people to move into a white neighborhood in Louisville, Kentucky. And the neighborhood eventually kind of deteriorated. And then they ended up losing their house through predatory lending. And this was just a reminder of how, you know, the real estate game is kind of a sharkish game if you don't know how to play it, which is why I'm a big believer in having experts around like Julian Gordon that can help you dig in. Now Julian is a guy who's succeeded in real estate. He's a guy that can help solve problems like this, where African-American home ownership has actually started to drop. It's lowest amongst all the ethnic groups. If we take that bottom number and let's say we move to second place or third place or whatever the case may be, we would actually see multi-trillion dollar increase in Black wealth. But we face a lot of challenges. You know, 68% of Americans have their wealth in real estate. Home ownership rate for Black households is very low. 2017, 19% of Black applicants were denied conventional home loans. The number one question that I get a lot of times when people hear good ideas is they say, where do I get the money? Well, we know how to get the money. So this is for you if you invest in yourself and you don't want to wait for handouts. If you believe in what I call real reparations and not just reparations, you know, reparations, you know, that'll be a check coming from Massa that'll let you have a little bit less slavery than what you had before. Real reparations is wealth coming from your community where you're controlling that narrative. I believe real reparations will exceed reparations any day of the week. And the worst reparations are the fake orations, which is where they convince you that you're making progress when you're really not. Also, this is for you if you know that you work too hard and you're too educated to not feel free. You put in the work, you should get the reward. We can show you how to do that. Also, it's for you if you're seriously committed to creating generational wealth. If you don't care about your children, you don't care about your descendants, then I'm not your guy. But if you care about your children and care about your community and want to see your family do better when you're gone, then we're your guys. We're your team. We're the people for you. This is not for you if you're looking for things that are related to get rich quick schemes. Julian, I saw an article today where somebody wrote an article literally on Huffington Post where they literally said that learning financial literacy is a waste of time because it doesn't work. You know, and I found that to be amazing. Yeah, that was an amazing title to put in an article because I'm sitting there thinking there's so many people I know who went from nothing to having something because they protected what they had and they grew it, you know. And I said, you know, maybe that is the logic you come to if you are looking for, you know, ways to make money overnight. But if you are a person that is really trying to, you know, do something good with your wealth and you understand that it's a marathon, not a sprint, then you would never make that kind of conclusion. It's kind of crazy. If you're cheap and trying to save your way to wealth and you don't want to invest and grow your money, it's not going to work. Also, if you're too lazy to do what it takes now to build a better life, then this isn't for you. We're not built for lazy people. So a lot of people say we need reparations as our money, but what we really need is land and property. Minister Farrakhan and others have made us aware that Black folks, we used to own a lot of land and now we own less land. You've seen Dr. Claude Anderson come through and basically talk about how Black people owned 15 times more land 100 years ago than we own today. Land ownership must be the number one of the number one priorities of the community. Also, Dr. King was killed, or not because he was sitting in and praying for a better life, but he was killed when he started talking about we're coming to get our check. We want subsidies. We want money. We want land. We want 40 acres and a mule. Or maybe we want 40 acres in a Bentley or whatever it is, but we want what's due to us. And so so a lot of us don't know these things. We don't know the keys to survival. And Julian, and I'm going to actually pass this over to him now, is he's going to teach us what is called the above ground railroad, right? We've got the underground railroad, and he's going to talk about the above ground railroad. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop sharing my screen and allow Julian to kind of take over. And basically say welcome to everybody that's here. And I guarantee you that today you will get something that will be transformative in your life. This is real education. This is real Black training that will be better than anything you learned in college. Why do we know it? Well, because I have a PhD and Julian went to Stanford, Lawrence went to Cornell. You don't learn stuff like this with those $200,000, $300,000 degrees. This is where Black people learn how to be Black, and being Black means buying Black, owning Black, and having Black economic power. That's what we teach you in the Black Business School. So without further ado, I'm going to step to the side and let you take over the game, Julian. Go ahead, bro.
Thank you so much, Doc. I appreciate that warm introduction. I'm so excited to be here tonight. Yes, it is just so beautiful to see you all here on a Friday night, really committed to not only real estate, but I know you're really here because you're committed to generational wealth and creating that. And you've seen through your own experience that real estate is one of the most powerful ways to do that. If you don't know me and this is your first time experiencing me, my name is Julian Gordon. And my purpose in this world is literally to free 300 people like Harriet Tubman. That is my ancestor spirit that I channel and who I'm committed to walking in her footsteps, right? She, of course, was the number one conductor on the Underground Railroad, and I am seeking to be the number one conductor on the Above Ground Railroad, which, as Doc said, is real estate. Real estate has been right in front of our face forever. We're probably the most renting community of all, and we're just on the wrong side of the equation. And so tonight is really about getting you on the other side of the equation, where you're collecting rent checks as opposed to paying rent to somebody else. And for, like Doc said, it's not just about freedom to kick it on the beach and do nothing. That's a lot of what people want to do with retirement because they've been on the corporate plantation for so long. For me, this is really rooted in you actually being free enough to live out your purpose on a daily basis. And the primary ways that I teach that in the Freedom School is through entrepreneurship and multifamily real estate. My professional background, just to give you some highlights, I don't want to spend a lot of time here because this is not what is important, but it does shape some people's listening to know what I've actually done, what my track record is. And so I built a $3.3 million a real estate portfolio with 10 multifamily homes that generate five figures per month in passive income in just 6 years. Okay. And I did all of this on the side. Real estate did not start out as my core business. I only recently identified myself as a real estate investor. This was all done on the side. Right. So for those of you who are working on the corporate plantation and don't know how you would actually get in this game, I'm going to show you exactly how to do that. My real estate portfolio returns 11.41% annually. And that means that essentially every 6 years, I double my money. Every 6 years, I double my money as a result of my real estate portfolio. And that's just the cash on cash return. Right. The S&P 500, for those of you who have money stuck in a 401k or IRA in these retirement plans, the S&P 500 over the past 10 years has returned about 5.49%. Everybody throws out this number. Oh, the stock market grows 10% every single year. No, it doesn't. Those are averages. And historically, that may be true in terms of when you look at the entire run of the stock market. But if you go do the math yourself, it has returned 5.49% over the last 10 years. I wouldn't deceive you in any kind of way. Okay, my properties have also appreciated 30% in value. So let's just say I bought $2 million worth of real estate. 30% increase would mean $600,000 that I now have in more additional equity that I didn't work for. I didn't go trade time for money. Literally, the property just appreciated in value over time. And again, I'm founder of the Freedom School and the multifamily movement. And I am not a real estate agent. Okay. And you don't have to be one either. A lot of people think that they need to get their real estate license. But the reality, and I'm going to show this to you in a second, that most real estate agents don't think like real estate investors. And so tonight, I'm going to show you how to think like a real estate investor and not just a home buyer or a real estate agent. I'm going to be 100% transparent with all of you this evening. And to show you that, here's my actual portfolio. This is every single property that I own. So I'm not just going to say that I own 10 properties and not show you. Here are the actual properties and here are the years that I bought them. So my first property I bought in Brooklyn, New York, is a 3-family home. I love that space. And I was in Brooklyn at the time. And I'll literally show you how this deal was literally in my backyard, literally my apartment that I was renting because I had been a renter all my life, right? My apartment that I was renting is adjacent. It shares a backyard with this property that I ended up buying. So there's literally real estate deals in your backyard, but because you don't have the eyes to see opportunity and value yet, which I'm going to train you tonight, you can't see the opportunities that exist, even in a saturated market like Brooklyn. After becoming a landlord and a homeowner, it took me a little bit of time to get a feeling for what that meant and what that meant and what the responsibilities were. But I was seeing the benefits, right? I was seeing the appreciation. I was seeing the cash flow. And as I was experiencing that, I was like, you know what? I got to keep doing this. Okay. Like many of you, I'd read Rich Dad, Poor Dad, and I knew that real estate was a powerful path to freedom. So it took me about 4 years to buy my next home in New Orleans, Louisiana. And I bought this home from a distance. And this is the home that I live in now. And I bought this home from a distance while I was still in Brooklyn, New York. So for those of you who are wondering like, oh, my market's too saturated, the prices are too high, I'm going to live an example that you can own real estate from a distance and it all work out. My next property was in Oakland. So now I was tri-coastal, right? I was West Coast, Gulf Coast, East Coast, right? A lot of people talk about being bi-coastal. I was tri-coastal. And I had properties in my three favorite cities in the United States, almost high family. And then something clicked in my head where I changed my identity. At this moment, I was no longer seeking to be a home buyer, right? Or a homeowner. Instead, I changed my identity and I started calling myself a real estate investor. And when you change your identity in your head, your behavior starts to follow. And so as you can see, once I changed my identity, my mind since 2018, I've been on an absolute tear and I've acquired 7 additional properties, putting me at 27 doors with the statistics that I shared with you earlier with 11.4% cash on cash return, 30.3% appreciation, $28,000 monthly in revenue that I earned from that portfolio, and $3.6 million in value, okay? So if I liquidated my real estate portfolio, which I have no intention of doing, okay? I am a buy and holder. This is not, tonight we will not be talking about fixing and flipping. We will not be talking about wholesaling, because most fix and flippers and most wholesalers, what are they ultimately trying to do? They're trying to get cash so that they can do what? So that they can buy and hold real estate that will appreciate and create cash flow for their family for indefinitely, forever, okay? You all remember Monopoly, right? You all remember Monopoly? We had these pieces right here. I got the silver ones and the gold ones, and you would trade in this little single family house to get you a hotel, right? And the closest thing to a hotel that you can gain access to right now is a 2-4 family, a multifamily home, okay? So this is what we want. This is how we win the game, not this. This is the American dream, and this is what they convinced you of, that this was the path that you should take. And most people who get this, it makes it harder for you to get this because you get caught up in the American dream. But I'm going to show those of you who got caught up in this, I'm going to show you how to reverse yourself out of that so that you can get back on this path to acquiring not just one, not just two, not just three, so that you can get up to 10. You know what? I'm actually at 10, and that is actually the max that Fannie Mae, the max number of mortgages that Fannie Mae will give me. So I'll tell you later how I'm actually moving forward after the 10, okay? So tonight I'm gonna show you the multifamily math, how to quickly and quantitatively evaluate a real estate deal in less than 10 minutes so that you can make an offer before anyone else. The only thing that beats a cash offer is a fast offer, okay? And I am great at fast offers, and I'm gonna show you exactly what that means. The multifamily map, how to find great emerging markets, neighborhoods, and properties near you or from a distance that will provide great cash flow and potential appreciation. And then the multifamily mindset. This is really where the blockage is for many people. How to think like a real estate investor when it comes to wealth, money, real estate, and debt. One of the biggest relationships that you're gonna have to change in order to step into the identity as a real estate investor is how you relate to debt. Many of you have had a great relationship with bad debt, or it's actually not been a great relationship. The bad debt is loving you, but you're not loving it. And I'm gonna show you the difference between good debt and bad debt tonight so that you can actually change your relationship to debt. I will take as much debt as I can possibly get because I know how to use that debt to acquire assets that then not only pay for that debt, but leave me with cash and equity on top of that. So my big promise tonight is to give you a proven path to rent and mortgage freedom. Yes, rent and mortgage freedom. I'm literally committed to helping you live free. Okay, so what does rent and mortgage freedom mean? Rent and mortgage freedom means, or is the result of buying multifamily real estate, which has cash flow that eliminates your housing expense forever. Rent and mortgage freedom is the result of buying multifamily real estate, which has cash flow that eliminates your housing expense forever. So this, I've explored all kinds of different paths to freedom, right? We at the Black Business School and in the Freedom School, that's all we do every day. We think about how to get you free, right? We try cryptocurrency, we try stock market investing, we try entrepreneurship, we try drop shipping, right? We try franchises, and now we're trying real estate. And literally with this one decision to buy a multifamily piece of real estate and buy it the right way, this one decision can literally eliminate your housing expense forever. Okay. Now, most people, their housing expense takes up about 1/3 of their revenue. A lot of people call it income, but it's not income. It's actually revenue. Okay. And I'm going to break this down for you. And when you're in a business, income is revenues minus expenses equals income, correct? When you're in a business, it's revenues minus expenses equal income. But here's a part of the trickery of the American dream. They call your salary income, right? This is your income. That is not your income. Your salary is your revenues. Then you have your living expenses, and your income is what's left over at the end of the month. Your income is what's left over at the end of the month. So a lot of people have more month left over at the end of the money instead of having more money left over at the end of the month, Okay. So two people could both be making $60,000, but that's not their income. That's their revenue. One person could have an income of $20,000 and one person could have an income of $1,000 because of their living expenses. So you have to be very careful with the language that you use, because this is how we get tricked into the American dream. And the American dream has become an American nightmare for especially us as Black people, sending off our young people to college. And college, literally, I think African-Americans own about 61% of the college debt that is out there. Right? How crazy is that? That means that we're sending our best and brightest off to college, and they are getting shackled, and they will never, ever, ever be able to fly unless we have more Robert Morrises coming off and paying the student debt. Now, guess what? What Robert Morris could have done, and I'm not a multi-billionaire the way he is, but what would have been more powerful for him to do is for him to buy every Morehouse graduate or help them with the down payment on this, because this would pay them forever. When he paid off their student loans, guess who got paid? The school got paid and the loan providers, but there's no, all that money left our community at that time, right? All that money leaves our community. If he would have helped them get a down payment on this, this would have stayed in the community forever. And the cash flow from this would have actually paid off the student loans indefinitely. It's the way money works, okay? So let's keep moving forward. So the three biggest multifamily home ownership hurdles: one, the money, can I afford it, right? Two, the market, am I too late? And then three, the mindset, is freedom even possible? So we're going to overcome these hurdles tonight. The first way we're going to do that is, how do I finance the deal? Okay. Then we're going to discuss how to find the deal. And then we're going to go over how to finalize the deal. Okay. So by the end of this webinar, you have the foundation you need to finance, find, and finalize multifamily real estate deals and live free. No kidding. I'm not using any euphemisms or any big language. Literally, I can show you how to live free. How many of you down to live free? Let me know in chat. Just raise your hands, type yes. Let me know if you're down to live free. If you want to eliminate your housing expense forever, let me know. If you're happy paying rent, you can keep on paying rent. That's fine with me. Actually, it's not fine with me because I care too much about you. All right, cool. So let's keep moving forward. Now, if Doc and I, if we want to ask for your permission, if we promise to give you some good content while we're here this evening, can we take 10 minutes on the back end to actually give you opportunity to consider? If that's okay with you, just type yes in chat. Type yes in chat. Let me know. If not, it's all good. I'll let you know when I'm starting to share the opportunity and you can bounce off. And we hope that this webinar has blessed you. This is the Emancipation Equation. This is the fourth time that we've done this series. And this series is absolutely free, right? But if you want to go deeper with us, then we have an opportunity that we would love for you to consider at the end. Okay, cool. Again, we'll only do it if you're down. Now, for those of you who do stay till the end, I'm going to give you a list of down payment assistance programs by state. So whatever state you're in, there are typically down payment assistance programs to help you get into home buyership. We don't call it a home ownership in the Black Business School. We call it home buyership because you actually don't own the home until the mortgage is paid off. So we are home buyers, not home owners immediately. And HGTV, you watch enough of that, they give you the keys and they say, congrats, you're a home owner. No, you're not. The bank owns 96.5% of your home typically at that moment in time. So you're not a homeowner. The same thing with your car, right? Until the note is paid off, you don't own that particular vehicle. Okay. So the same thing. So again, being careful with our language. Okay. So I want to address this because a lot of people are like, Julian, I'm broke. I'm living paycheck to paycheck. I don't have enough money to invest in real estate. I'm hoping you can show me how to get a piece of real estate with no money in whatsoever. I just have to show up and sign something. Doesn't work like that, but I will show you this. Okay. This is my tax return in 2012, my exact tax return. You can see that I had only made $35,000 in 2012, okay? Now, that $35,000, I was proud of it because I was coming out of a recession. I quit my job on January 9th, 2009 at the bottom of the recession. And as a result, you know, the economy was slowing a little bit. So I made $35,000 and this is the tax return that they use to qualify me for that house in Brooklyn, okay? So if you're letting not having enough money or thinking that you don't have enough money stop you from actually moving forward, then you might be mistaken. My challenge to you is go get pre-qualified. Go get pre-approved, okay? Go get pre-approved, and that's what you know. Everybody can get pre-approved. The question is how much you get pre-approved for. Some people might only get pre-approved for $80,000 based on their income and their credit. Other people might get pre-approved for $800,000. Go get pre-approved. Don't cut yourself off at the heels by not even going out and trying. So I made $35,000 in 2012. I bought that home in 2013, right? And keep in mind, I got started when I wasn't making a lot of money. I got started in New York City, the most expensive real estate market in the country. I got started while I was an entrepreneur, and I got started within 3 years of a recession, okay? So I'm a living example that there are pieces, if you have them in the right place, your income, right, or your salary does not have to be extremely high for you to get started into multifamily real estate. In fact, in multifamily real estate, when you are going for financing, they will take 75% of the rents that are coming from floor number 2, number 3, and number 4. Let's say it's, if you have a 3-family, you live in one unit and the other two units are 2,000 and 2,000. They will take 75% of that 2,000 and 2,000, which is 4,000, right? 4,000 added, 75% of that is 3,000. They will apply that to your income. So they will count that toward you. So it's actually easier for you to qualify for a multifamily home than it is for a single family home that has no income coming in, because you get to account for 75% of the rent towards your actual income when you're qualifying. It's easier to qualify for a multifamily home. I mean, it just makes sense. It's producing actual income for you, right? Whereas a single family home does not do that, okay? So why this, why now, okay? First and foremost, if you don't move now, a couple things are gonna happen. Rent's gonna continue to rise. And some of you got rent increases recently, right? And it will rise to a point where it's too high for you to even save, right? Because salaries aren't rising with rent. And so your salary stays the same, but rent rises. That means you're left with less at the end of the month. And at the same time, the prices of housing or buying a real estate will actually rise too high for you to buy. So these two things will not be working in your favor. And if you wait for this opportunity, right, then what's going to happen is you may put yourself in a position where you never, ever, ever own, because you won't be able to save enough for a down payment fast enough to keep up with the rising price of housing. Okay, so you have to act quickly, right? You may think that this economy is at a peak. It does not matter. I buy in all cycles. I buy in all cycles where the economy is up or down, because multifamily real estate, it is the most recession-proof asset in the entire world. It is the most recession-proof asset in the entire world. Now, why is this asset so unique? It's because multifamily real estate, and when I say multifamily, I'm talking about 2 to 4 family homes, okay? Why is it so unique? There's only 2.6 million of them in the United States, okay? And not every one of them is for sale. They are this, they make up the smallest portion of the house, the rental stock in the United States. They only make up 18% of the rental stock, okay? Single family homes make up 39% of the rental stock. Multifamily with 5 to 19 units make up 22%, and then 20 units or greater make up 21%. Now, what's unique about the 2 to 4 family is that the financing for 2 to 4 units you can get finance in the same way through the same process that you get finance for a single family home. That's what makes this 2 to 4 family unique. Once you move to 5 doors, that becomes a commercial property and the financing is completely different, okay? And so if you acquire the right 3 to 4 family home, you can actually achieve mortgage freedom and never have a housing expense for the rest of your life. Now, on top of that, multifamily real estate is the most proven business model of all time, right? When you look at the feudal system, you might have read about it in junior high school or high school. The feudal system was what? It was 900 AD. And what was the feudal system? It was the king giving land to lords. You hear that? The king giving land to lords. So where do you think the word landlord comes from? It comes from the feudal system. This business model has been around for 2,900 years. I cannot promise you that Amazon will be around for 2,900 years. I cannot promise you that Google will be around for 2,900 years. But if the earth still exists, I can promise you that multifamily real estate will be around 2,900 years from now. Okay? So this is the power of multifamily real estate. Now, I said earlier that it is the most recession-proof asset in the entire world. You see these gray bars right here? You see these gray bars? These gray bars are the economic recessions. And what happens to rent in an economic recession? Rent goes up. So if you own multifamily real estate, you actually earn more in a recession than you do outside of a recession. And here's why. Because all the people who bought these single family homes and bought too big, right? Guess what happened? They end up getting foreclosed on and they now become renters, okay? And then people who were going to buy, they are now hesitant because they don't know if they're going to lose their job tomorrow. And so they end up staying renters. And so when the demand of something goes up, but the supply doesn't change, what happens to the price? The price goes up. And so multifamily rents go up in a recession, not down, right? So this is why this asset is so powerful, okay? So tonight is for you if you are a renter or single family homeowner who wants to be receiving rents monthly instead of paying rent or mortgage to someone else. If you are committed to creating generational wealth for yourself and your family by having your money work for you instead of always working for it. See, here's what happens, y'all. Many of you are working and employed to get money. You're employed to get money. But guess what? You worked hard to get this money, but now your money is sitting in a savings account and it's unemployed, right? You actually want that money. If you were working and you were employed and you were getting some extra money at the end of the month, you also want that money to be employed. This is what it means to have your money working for you, not just sitting in a savings account earning 0.03% interest, right? At Bank of America, it's 0.03%. You know how long it'll take you to double your money at Bank of America right now in a savings account? It'll take you 2,400 years. You take 72, divide that by 0.03. It'll take you 2,400 years to double your money in a savings account. You want to play hot potato with money. You want to play hot potato with money, right? The bank, the moment you make that deposit, what are they doing? They're throwing your money out, right? They know that cash is the lowest yielding asset in the entire world at 0.03%. So anytime you get cash beyond your emergency fund, you actually want to get it out and you want to put it out there and have it working for you, okay? So this is also for you if you're willing to make short-term sacrifices necessary to guarantee long-term financial gains for your freedom and your family freedom. Again, this is not for you. We just want to be clear. This is not for you if you're looking for a get-rich-quick scheme that appears to involve no risk whatsoever. This is not for you if your credit score is below 500, you don't have a plan to save at least $10,000, and you're not earning $40,000 a year yet. I'm not saying that you can't join, but you need to start getting these things in place. It's going to take you longer to go through this process because these things are essential for you to get financed. There's nothing I can do. There's no workarounds that I can do. This is what's required for you to get financed for a leveraged loan or a mortgage on a multifamily home. Okay. And this is not for you if you don't have a purpose greater than yourself and just making money that drives you, such as God, your kids, or your legacy. If you're just in this for the money, then this is not for you. We are committed to ethical investing. We are not committed to investing in such a way like a lot of people out there teach. I know some of you have been watching some other real estate gurus, and what they actually teach is displacing your grandmother. They teach displacing people of color and pushing us further and further and further and further and further out, so that the white flight that happened can now come back to the urban communities. And now our commute is longer, we're away from our families longer, and we're out in these food deserts and things of that nature. That's the type of real estate investing that a lot of these other Caucasian gurus are teaching. We don't teach that here. We actually teach ethical investing. I've never displaced any tenant unwillingly or that did not pay rent. Right, I don't just go in there and raise rents sky high and that forces a family of five to move because they can't afford it. That's not how we move here. We are not displacing our community. We are committed to ethical investing. So if you want to go follow those gurus out there who are telling you to, just go in there, do this and raise rents and kick them out and do this, that's not what we do here. And so I encourage you to get off this webinar if that's how you want to treat people. This is a people's game. We do not put profit or properties before people. This is a people's game, but other people will teach you that it's solely about profit. And this is why they make immoral decisions that end up affecting our community in a negative way, okay? So why am I doing this, okay? I actually come from a lot of privilege. I'm the son of two doctors and I had the silver spoon in my mouth. And what I've done is I've taken that silver spoon and tried to feed as many people as possible. And despite my mother having amazing income revenues, salary as a doctor, she fell on hard times at some point, right? And this is the house I grew up in, on 910 Creed Road in Oakland, California. And I literally witnessed her lose this house because her single source of income went away just like that. And she could no longer make the payment. Today, this home is worth $1.8 million. And as her only son, I'm supposed to be inheriting this house. But I'm not, because she lost it. Now she had, and I don't blame her because of what happened. I do not blame her whatsoever, but this is really my first foray into real estate. Seeing my mother actually lose her home in the same way that Doc saw his grandparents lose their home, right? I had the same thing and that stuck with me. And some of you have similar stories about your grandparents losing your homes. The city took it because their mortgages were paid and they didn't pay the taxes because they were on fixed income. Some of you have these same stories. And this is what got me into multifamily real estate, right? Now, I want to come full circle. I want to come full circle because guess what? A few months ago, I was able to buy my mom this house in New Orleans, Louisiana. It is a double. And she, you know what she calls it? She calls it her castle. It's nowhere near as big as the home that I grew up in. Nowhere near as big. It's a one bedroom with a bathroom and a kitchen. It's perfect for her and where she is at her stage of life. But guess what? Because the tenant on the right hand side actually pays the mortgage, my mom doesn't have to pay anything. She is able to, she's on fixed income and she's able to live free and have more breathing room because of this decision. Literally, when I bought this house for her, yo, I felt like a basketball player or some rapper or something. You know, everybody talk about buying their mom a house. Yeah, I bought my mom a house. It was not a mansion, right? But she is able to live in it for absolutely free. And so this was my way of paying her back for raising me in the way that she raised me, all right? So this is what real estate is really about. It's about taking care of your family. And typically, we're talking about leaving our legacy and paying it forward to our kids. And for me, I actually have power of attorney over my mother's affairs, and I actually have to take care of my mom, right? So not only can you pay it forward to the future generations, but in some cases, if you buy right, you may have to take care of older generations through the real estate that you acquire, all right? So how many of y'all been on boring webinars before? Type me in the chat. How many of you been on, has it been, I hope this hasn't been boring. How many been on some boring webinars before? All right, cool. So look, I'm gonna spice this up a little bit. And how many, y'all cool if I drop some poetry on y'all real quick? y'all down if I drop some poetry? Okay, let's spice this up. You probably ain't never heard no poem on a webinar before. All right, cool, y'all down? So let me get into it. It's the multifamily poem, all right? And I wrote this poem because I want you, I know us as Black people, we love things that rhyme, we love music, we love dance, right? And we love poetry. And I want to simplify these concepts so easy and make them so easy for you that they that you can just move forward with them. And because I understand this space so well, I'm able to put some very dense concepts into a poem. And so I wanna share that with you. And the reality is most of you will not catch every single line that I say, but every single line has power and value and more depth to it. But I'm gonna spit it anyways right now, okay? Why don't we hack houses like frat houses where everyone living good for just a few thousand? Some will say it's lousy while they slaving proudly, spending one third of their revenue to pay for housing. Living on your own, but you don't own shit. Can't even get a loan, student debt is a bitch. Thinking a high wage is the way to get rich. Not if your living expenses rise directly with it. Trying to keep up with the Joneses deep in debt till you croak. I'ma live just like the Jeffersons, pretend that I'm broke. Then I'll buy a multifamily, let the rents pay the note. Perhaps you could be my tenant. Yo, that would be dope. I keep my cost of living low along with my blood pressure. Cause if you always stressing, it's hard to enjoy pleasure. The man with the most is not the one who wins the race. It's the man with his soul who can look at his own face. 40 acres and a mule is what they taught us in school. I'd rather have 40 apartments and a big money pool. Leverage credit to capital and capital to cash flow. Cash is not king cause the interest too low. Some call me a do-gooder. I got good deeds in my name. As the lord of my land, I'll never be a slave. You can dabble in stocks, lose your shirt and your socks, but the demand for housing will never ever stop. Assets, 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 passive, passive, passive. These are the two keys to amass wealth quick, but quick is really relative. It's a long-term game. Who you hustling for, your first or your last name? Boom. Y'all with me? I get some snaps. Can y'all do emojis over in here? Can I get some snaps? All right, cool. Cool. So this is the depth that I understand multifamily real estate so much so that I can simplify it into a poem for you all. But now we're going to get into the teaching for tonight. Okay. So myth number one that we have to break through is the myth that I cannot afford it, that I don't have enough, that I don't make enough, et cetera. I already showed you my tax return from 2012. And so what literally has to happen is a mindset change. I said the multifamily mindset is really where the breakthrough has to happen for most of you. And the question has to become, how can I afford it? When you see how much opportunity is on the table, when you make this one single decision, you cannot continue to tell your mind that I can't afford it. Because when you tell your mind I can't, the moment you use that language, it stops seeking answers. It stops seeking to find out. And the reason many of you are still renting, even though you've been ready to buy, you just didn't know it because you told your mind that you can't afford it. So we need to change that to a question. And the question, anytime a question is asked, it begs to have an answer. And so once you ask a question, your mind will seek the answer to that question. So let's just start with the monthly payment, okay? So today's average rent for a two-bedroom is $1,225 per month, okay? That's the rent for average two-bedroom. Guess what? For the average house in the United States, which is $218,000 at 4.5% interest for 30 years with 0% down, $2,200 in taxes and insurance, that mortgage would be $1,288. So for only $63 more, many of you could be owning a single family home. Now, that's not what I'm promoting tonight, but I'm just showing you that for $63 more than you're paying in rent, you could actually be owning a single family home. In fact, everybody right now, type in your rent right now. Type in your rent or your single family home mortgage into the chat right now. Type in your rent or $1,800, $1,250, $1,300, $1,643. $2,000, $1,900, $1,200, $810, $700, $1,175, $1,049, $960, $757, $2,400, $2,300, $1,500, $1,700, $2,200, $2,040. Oh my goodness, $3,000. All right, y'all. All right. That's enough. And y'all making me sad right now because that's just generational wealth just passing on to somebody else's generation. Okay. So look at this. I got this email not too long ago. This woman said, Julian, I love your online seminar and I really wish I could join, but being a single working mom right now is what's preventing me from pursuing my dream. At this time, I pay $1,200 a month for 9 years, which is insane, to rent to a slumlord who never fixes anything. And if he does, it's used. So let's just calculate that really quickly. 1,200 times 12 times 9 is $129,000 that this individual has paid to a slumlord. And that's not even accounting for the interest on this. That's just straight, cold, hard cash. No interest included. $129,000. We need to figure out how to reverse that and make sure that that stays in our community, not going to someone else. Okay? They say, who has ever said this, y'all? Renting this home long-term was the key to generational wealth. Who said that? Nobody ever. Nobody ever. Okay? So we need to get off this tip, all right? So let me just show you this, okay? $1,000 a month, if instead of that being paid out as rent, if you could actually be keeping that $1,000 and invest it at a conservative 5%, remember I showed you the S&P 500 to 5.49%. If you can instead keep that and invest it at a 5% every single month for 40 years, you would all be millionaires. In fact, you would have $1.5 million after 40 years if you could simply stop paying this $1,000 plus rent to somebody else and actually keep that and invest it into your family. I have a guaranteed path for you to become a millionaire. Like a guaranteed path. Some of you won't believe it, but this is just straight math. It's straight math. You could run the numbers yourself. If you could invest $1,000 a month instead of paying it as a rent or a mortgage, if you could keep that and invest it in the stock market or in real estate at $1,000 a month at 5% for 40 years, you'd have $1.5 million. Who wants to be a millionaire? It's a simple question. So if you know you want to be a millionaire, right? And I'm showing you this literally all that it takes to become one, what's stopping many of you is just you the long term. You're not willing to play the long term. You're looking for this fast cash. You're looking for multi-level marketing organization. You're looking for crypto and Bitcoin. You're looking for these get rich quick schemes. And you're continuing to look for these things. You're trying to chase these rabbits and you're catching none. If you got on this path right now, you'd be able to pass on generational wealth to your family. Okay. So I gotta change this for you, and I gotta get really real, and I want you to know that I'm coming from tough love, love being the noun, tough being the adjective. For anybody out there who is actually renting, I need you to change your mentality to the fact and recognize that you are actually homeless. If you're a renter, you are homeless, okay? Because what's happening right now is you're going off and you're telling people, you're having a dinner party. You say, hey, come over to my apartment. Come over to my house for this dinner party. Stop saying that because it's not your house. You're not on the deed. You're not on the title. Say instead, come over to Pat's house. I've been staying there for 9 years paying $1,200 rent. Come over to Pat's house to my dinner party. Yeah, this is where I stay. But I actually don't have a home, right? Hey, come over to Mike's house because that's who I pay. And I'm just using Mike's space for about 10 years. I've been using Mike's space and I love it here. I painted the walls and everything, and I take really good care of it. I mow the lawn for Mike. I do all this stuff for Mike. But yeah, I have nothing to show for it. Mike could come kick me out tomorrow if he wanted to, right? So stop telling yourself it's my apartment, because when you tell yourself it's my apartment, then what you're telling your subconscious mind receives that, and your subconscious mind is like, oh, we safe. We got an apartment. We got a place to live. But if instead, just temporarily, you said, I'm homeless. I am homeless. You know what that's going to do? Your subconscious mind is going to be like, we're homeless? Oh my goodness. We need to find a home. And you will start moving differently. Your survival mechanisms will kick in. And this is not a put down on homeless people whatsoever, because some people have called me out on that. This is not a put down on homeless people. This is a put down on us, y'all. Here we are with all this education, working hard, earning quote unquote all this money. And yet the person who is sleeping on the bus bench tonight has as many keys to a home as you. Zero. How is that the case? You got these college degrees. You got a job. You got your wits. Yet this person sleeping on the bus bench has as many keys to a home as you do. How could that be? So until you get activated, and I understand affirming that I'm homeless and how I understand the power of the mind, but some of you need to start doing that temporarily. In fact, I wish that all of your apartments had more roaches and more rats, because if they did, they would actually get you out faster. Because some of you getting real comfortable in places that you don't own. You're getting really comfortable. If you are renting, it is a temporary space that you are using for as short of amount of time as possible in order to get to ownership. So I pray that all of you have more rats and more roaches so that you get up off your butt and actually go do something different and go own something. That's wrong. That's wrong. Hey, the truth hurts or the truth will set you free. It actually is both. And so I just had to say that, because some of y'all are getting real comfortable in your apartments and it's not your apartment. Stop calling it that. I lease my car. I say that's Honda of Covington's car. It's not my car. I'm fully aware that it's not my car. I'm using it and I'm disposing of it. But the only reason I lease my car is because I lease things that depreciate over time and I own things that appreciate over time. That's why you need to own multifamily real estate, because it appreciates. The car, it depreciates. I'm going to use that car up and give it back to them in 3 years. Okay? So if you're ready for this journey, then stay with me, okay? So here's the truth. If you can pay rent, you can own a single family home. If you can pay rent, you can own a single family home. But if you don't want to pay rent or mortgage ever again, you can own a multifamily home. If you can pay rent, you can own a single family home. But that's not what this webinar is about. If you don't want to pay rent or mortgage, you can own a multifamily home. Single family home could never do that for you. Okay? So what is financial freedom? According to Robert Kiyosaki says that financial freedom is the moment where your passive income is greater than your cost of living. Okay? So I'm not some multimillionaire. Not yet. I'm getting close though. I'm not some multimillionaire. But my passive income from my real estate investments, stuff that I don't have to actually work for, I don't have to exchange time for money, is greater than my cost of living. And so guess what? If I decided not to work right now, I could chill out for the rest of my life. Literally, I could chill out for the rest of my life. But I have a purpose that's deeper than money. And I'm not just interested in hanging out on the beach. I'm sometimes, but not all the time. And so I'm still here for you tonight, because I know that I need to share this message with as many people as possible. So next, let's get into the down payment. Down payment, a lot of people are like, Julian, I don't even have commas in my bank account. That's a problem, okay? Some of you have negative net worth right now. If we did your net worth calculation, you'd have negative net worth. You realize that there was a child who was born 2 minutes ago who has a net worth of zero, which is actually higher than some of you who are adults on this call tonight. Literally, a baby that was born 2 minutes ago has a net worth of zero, and they have a higher net worth than some of you who are on this call tonight. How is that? How crazy is that? I'm telling you, the American dream has us caught up with this student debt, with this single income, and this single family home, okay? So the reality is there are programs out there that are no money down, okay? No down payment, no closing costs, no points or fees, no credit score consideration. right? But some of you just believed in your mind that you that this wasn't possible, and therefore you stopped seeking, therefore you never found it. These three men, Mark, Kazi, and Kevin, I know them all personally. Mark got a duplex in Los Angeles, California. Kazi has a fourplex with his family in Los Angeles, California, near USC that is already appreciated. And Kevin has a duplex in Brooklyn, New York. And they all went through this program, which many of you might not know because you believe that there was no possibility there. So you have to understand that what you know, your intellectual property, could actually lead to physical property. Your intellectual property, what you know, can actually lead to physical property, all right? So say you wanted to own a $300,000 duplex like mine here, okay? This is one of my properties in New Orleans. The FHA loan program, the Federal Housing Administration, a government program, has literally a 3.5% down payment program. So to have control over a $300,000 asset, I didn't say own, to have control over a $300,000 asset, all you would have to do is put 3.5% down, which is $10,500. Okay, you'll still have closing costs, any immediate repairs and moving expenses to account for, but literally you could control this entire $300,000 asset for $10,500, okay? So I also want to share this with you. Did you know that multifamily homes can actually cost less than single family homes? This house on the left, this is my property in Oakland. You see the Z estimate for it is $589,000. This is a duplex over here. Now, when I look at houses, single family homes of the same exact size in the same neighborhood, you see them for $705, $650, and $851. So this is actually in your favor because multifamily homes actually can cost less than single family homes of the same exact size. Why? Because so many people are caught up in the American dream. Therefore, the demand for the single family home is higher. And when demand goes up, what happens? Price goes up. But because people aren't hip to this, even though many people live in multifamilies and they're renting, they just don't believe in it. They don't believe in sharing walls. I want my white picket fence and my detached home, right? And my dog named Lassie. Everybody's going after the American dream when the real pathway to wealth is these multifamily homes, this 18% of the rental stock that everybody is overlooking. So multifamily homes can actually cost less than single family homes of the equivalent size, okay? So now let's get into the multifamily math. If I told you I found an ATM machine that would eliminate your $1,000 a month rent expense forever, and on top of that, give you an extra $90 in cash every single month, guaranteed, no matter what, all you had to do was pay $10,500 one time, would you give up or go get the money? Please type it in the chat. Would you give up or go get the money? Literally, this would pay you back in less than a year. Would you give up or go get the money? Okay, most of you say you would go get the money. Well, guess what? This is the ATM machine. You've just been overlooking it because you haven't trained your eyes to see opportunities in multifamily real estate yet. This is my $300,000 duplex here in New Orleans, and it operates just like an ATM machine that pays me $1,090 every single month, guaranteed. It's $300,000, 3.5% down payment, that's $10,500. The rents are $3,200. The mortgage is $1,259. The taxes and insurance are $335. The CapEx, repair reserves, and vacancy, which most people don't account for, but I do, is $515. And guess what? What's left over at the end of the month after paying all those things is $1,090 every single month, like clockwork, guaranteed. This is an ATM machine. It doesn't look like the one at the bodega or the one at your bank. But this is an ATM machine that pays me $1,090 every single month like clockwork. And this property is so, this property is special to me because the same kind of program that my mom was experiencing in Oakland, this home now houses 9 women who are recovering from alcoholism. This house houses 9 women who are trying to get back on their feet recovering from alcoholism, and they each pay $300-something a month. How beautiful is that? And guess what? I got a 4-year rental agreement signed with the organization that they're a part of prior to me even closing on the home. I'm doing good and I'm profiting at the same time without compromising my integrity, my morals, or putting people, a profit before people. This is the power of real estate. And this is what we teach here, okay? So answer me this. What other business can you buy for $300,000, okay, with only $10,500 down and get financed for the other $289,000 in 30 to 45 days that immediately cash flows in 30 days and succeed with minimal time, effort, or experience? What other business can you do that for? Please tell me. I'll wait. I think y'all get the point. There is none. There is none. This is it. And if you do this right, this can set you up for success for your life. Now, there is a difference between buying multifamily real estate and single family real estate. Okay. When you're buying single family real estate, it's basically, look, how much is the price? And did I get financed for more than the price? And people just go off of emotion. But when you're buying multifamily real estate, there are actually 23 different numbers that you need to account for to make sure that the deal makes sense. You don't have to do that in single family real estate, which is driven by emotion. Multifamily real estate is driven by economics, okay? And literally, because I have this purchase or pass deal analyzer, I'm able to evaluate a deal in less than 10 minutes and I'm able to make a decision. You see these green cells down here? This financial model, which I've refined over the past 6 years, it literally tells me, Julian, purchase this or don't purchase it. That's it. And I actually can make offers on homes blindly without even seeing them with my own eyes because of this tool. Okay. Your agents can go get you the data, but your agents do not think like this. This is what I train you in as a real estate investor. So literally in the mornings, I get emails and text messages from different sources. Okay. With deals that are available. I plug those deals into my purchase or pass deal analyzer, 10 minutes. I text my agent, say, put an offer for this amount on this property. And within 15 minutes, she sends me the purchase agreement back. I sign it online. And within the first hour before everybody else is up, guess what? My offer is in. And now the clock is ticking for everybody else who thought they were going to get that deal. The only thing that beats a cash offer is a fast offer. And I can show you how to be quick. Okay. So myth number two. I missed my opportunity. Some of you think it's too late. You should have bought when you were in the when we were in the depression and, or the recession, et cetera. Here's the reality. For those of you who are waiting for the next recession to buy, when there's a recession, what typically happens? Yes, the prices of housing is going to go down. Not multifamily, though. It won't go down nearly as much as single family. Okay. And on top of that, what happens at the banks? They restrict their lending guidelines in the recession. So if you think you're just going to clean up and when the recession comes, nope, the only people who clean up in a recession are the people who have cash, because they're going to restrict their lending guidelines in a recession so that they don't lose, because they're already dealing with a whole bunch of foreclosure. Okay. So a lot of people think that they missed their opportunity, and that's not how multifamily or real estate deals work. The truth is that I create my opportunities. There's not just one single opportunity out there for you. There are opportunities that are popping up every single day if you train your eyes to see them. You create opportunities. This is not just about finding deals on Trulia or Zillow, right? Where they're passively coming to you. This is about creating opportunities, okay? And so let's talk about how you see opportunity. Because right now, what your eyes, they've been trained by HGTV. And I call it HGTV foolishness. Your first investment property, which you probably will be required to live in for at least 1 year, will not look like anything you see on HGTV. It will not look like any of that, okay? None of my properties will ever be featured on HGTV, okay? So a lot of you are watching shows like The Property Brothers, and I'm letting you know, screw The Property Brothers. Instead, I'm going to be your new property brother with an A. And I'm gonna keep it real with you about real estate, okay? This is about guaranteed cash flow, not granite countertops. This is about guaranteed cash flow, not granite countertops. None of my properties have granite countertops. But you would be happy to have my portfolio, wouldn't you? Okay. So type in the chat, do you want granite countertops or do you want guaranteed cash flow? And don't say both. When you get the guaranteed cash flow, you can get the granite countertops. But which one do you want first? You want guaranteed cash flow. All right. So you got to put your priorities in order. Let me show you my first property, okay? Nothing sexy. It's a nice home. Nothing sexy though, okay? It's not a real brownstone. right? There's no granite countertops. Look at my kitchen countertops, right? Basic sink, white appliances, don't even have stainless steel appliances, okay? Now, my first home, my first multifamily home, it was not my dream home, okay? It was not my dream home, but guess what? It made my dreams possible. So in a sense, it actually is my dream home. It was not my dream home. It's not the one I envisioned and that I'm ultimately going to be in eventually, right? But it made my dreams possible, okay? So I just want to make some distinction between single family buyers and multifamily buyers. Single family buyers from HGTV, et cetera. Single family buyers are looking for their dream home. Multifamily buyers, they're looking for an asset to pay for their dream home, okay? These assets that I have, they will pay for my dream home, okay? Single family buyers are looking for granite countertops. Multifamily, they're looking for guaranteed cash flow. Single family buyers, they're looking for a place to raise their kids. It's multifamily buyers, they're looking for a place to raise their net worth. Single family buyers are buying based on emotion. Multifamily buyers buy based on economics. Single family buyers, they're looking for a place to call home. Multifamily buyers are looking for a place that other people can call home. Single family buyers are looking for the open concept. Multifamily buyers are looking for open possibilities in their life. Single family buyers, they're looking for a finished basement, whereas multifamily buyers, they're looking to start building wealth, okay? So you got to know the difference. Many of you are looking at real estate with single family buyer lenses, okay? You need to change the way you look at real estate, okay? So when it comes to the multifamily map, you got to realize that, guess what? Trulia and Zillow, these are where most multifamily deals go to die. Trulia and Zillow are great for looking for a single family home. This is probably the best platform for looking for a single family home. This is the graveyard for multifamily deals. Most multifamily deals, are actually made offline, okay? They're off market, meaning that an agent knows that one of their sellers is one of their owners is selling, and they actually send that text message to one of their buyers before it ever hits the MLS. This is how most multifamily deals get done. This is about relationships, y'all. You want to find off-market deals before there's some sort of bidding war, okay? So in order to do that, you got to build relationships, but you also need to have the four eyes for real estate. And the four eyes for real estate are: one, eyes for the market. How do you know if a market is expanding or contracting? What are all the signals that you look for in a particular market, especially for those of you who know that you won't be able to invest in the market that you live in right now? Number two is eyes for the neighborhood, okay? What are the things, what are the 30 signs of gentrification, 30 plus signs of gentrification that you look for to see if a neighborhood is about to turn, meaning that you should actually get in right now before you miss the upside, okay? Then properties, right? What do you look for in a property? A lot of you go in and walk into these open houses and you're looking at everything, all the surface stuff. But guess what? When you walk into a property, there are eyes you need to have to find hidden value in that property that other people are missing to know if that property is actually a legitimate investment. And then you need to have eyes for the deal. There's different ways to structure a deal. You could have one house, but three different deal structures, and one deal structure might be better than the other in order to get that deal done and for it to make sense, okay? Now, you do need a good real estate agent, but a real estate agent is not enough. What you need is a real estate advisor, not just a real estate agent. See, the problem with real estate agents is that, one, they don't think like investors. Go ask a real estate agent to give you the cash on cash return on a multifamily property that you're interested in. They won't be able to do it. Why? Because it wasn't on the real estate license. Okay. They didn't have a real estate exam. They didn't have to know that to get their real estate license. Okay. And then also ask your real estate agent, how many multifamily homes do they own? You're telling me you see all these amazing deals before anyone else, and yet you don't own any of them? Why? Because they don't think like real estate investors. They think like real estate agents. They mostly sell single family homes to American dreamers, okay? And guess what? The higher the price of that home that they sell you, the more they get in commission. So this is where the incentives are misaligned. And then on top of that, they're looking for many clients at the same time, okay? So what you use your real estate agent for is they can submit the offer for you. They can get you comparable prices and rents. They may know contractors for quotes and handle inspection, and they can help find your first tenant, and they know neighborhoods. They can tell you which neighborhoods to look in, what's happening in certain neighborhoods. But your real estate agent does not think like a real estate investor. So you can't just say, here's my criteria, please go find me something. They don't actually know what a good multifamily deal looks like, okay? Most of them don't. They can't calculate cash on cash return. So that's the most important number in a multifamily real estate deal, and they can't calculate it. So how do they know that they're selling you a good property? Okay, just because it looks nice, that's not what we're looking for in a multifamily deal. Looks are, it's not about emotions, it's about economics, okay? So Myth number three, I need to pay down my debt first. A lot of you are in debt. Credit got messed up a little bit as a result of that. And here's where this is going to be a complete flip for all of you. And you're going to be like, oh my goodness, why didn't you tell me that before? You don't need to pay down your own debt. You need to buy an asset that pays down your debt first. You need to buy an asset that pays down your debt. This is complete mental. This is going to give some of y'all a headache. What do you mean? I need to spend some more money to pay off my debt? That doesn't make any sense. Yeah, because it's not spending money. It's investing money. So you have to recognize, for those of you who bought single family homes, when you look at the word mortgage, mort, the prefix, that mort is the same mort as mortician. The word mortgage literally means death pledge. So the mortgage on a single family home is actually a death pledge. They're literally just messing with y'all. And they're throwing it in the Latin language. They're throwing it in there. Just say, let's just call it a death pledge. They won't know. It's going to be called a mortgage. They won't know, but it really means death pledge. And some of you are caught up in the death pledge. And now I got to come in with this axe and actually cut the chains off for you because you got caught up in the single family home. Now, I hope your single family home has appreciated for those of you who did buy. But guess what? That appreciation isn't real money, because in reality, that appreciation is mostly just covering the extra interest that you were paying anyways. Because for a single family home, when you get a mortgage on a single family home, you end up paying for about one and two thirds homes. You end up paying for about two homes when you add up all the interest. You end up paying for your home and somebody else's, the banker's. Okay. So when you do get appreciation, all it's really covering is paying you back that interest, which is good, but it's not really an asset. Okay. But what does Robert Kiyosaki call an asset? An asset, it has value, produces income or appreciates, and has a ready market. Assets put money into your pocket. At what point does a single family home put money into your pocket? Please, somebody in chat, let me know. At what home does a single family home put money into your pocket? I need some more Jeopardy music. It's quiet in here. Only when you sell it. A single family home is not an asset until you sell it, if it appreciated or you pay off the mortgage. And guess what? Even when you pay off the mortgage, guess what? It's still taking money out of your pocket because you still have to pay property taxes and insurance. Okay? You still have to pay property taxes and insurance. And now, once the mortgage is paid off, it's still 30 years old. And so guess what happens after 30 years? You need to change the roof. You need to change the plumbing. You need to repaint, etc. So a single family home is always taking money out of your pocket until the day you die. And then some. Okay? So you got to be careful. Right. So here's where you need to know the difference between bad debt and good debt. Yeah, a lot of the debt you probably have right now, credit cards, student debt, they call student debt good debt. It's not good debt. Student debt does not have any direct correlation to payment. In fact, in 2015, only 30% of college grads had a job on hand at graduation. So there's no direct correlation between your amount of student debt and how much you're about to earn. Okay. And then your single family mortgage. A lot of this is bad debt. Okay. So here's what you want to do. You want to go acquire an asset like a multifamily home, right? That then allows you to pay off your bad debt. You want to take out good debt. Good debt is debt that pays for itself, right? And you want to take that and pay off your bad debt. So when you acquire a multifamily home, now you no longer have rent. You can channel that money to what? Paying off your credit cards, okay? Now that home is also giving you extra cash flow. You take that cash flow and you use that to pay off your single family mortgage. Right. And then on top of that, you're also going to be getting tax savings from this particular property. And you take that and you pay off another debt. It's just so simple. So you acquire good debt to pay off bad debt. So and so some of you have student loans, and I'm going to show you two different scenarios. Watch this, because some of you are in a rush to pay off your student loans because you've listened to Dave Ramsey and you want to be debt free. The wealthiest people in the world are not debt free. They have tons of debt. I have tons of debt. But guess what? The assets that I bought with that debt, not only do they produce cash flow, but they're worth more than the debt. Okay? So watch this. Two people. One person, they both have $40,000 in student loans. One person's like, I'm going to be aggressive and I'm going to pay $20,000 each year for 2 years and I'm going to be debt-free. I can't wait. The other person says, you know what? I'm going to let this student loan thing ride out. And instead of trying to rush to pay off that, I'm going to take that $20,000. In fact, Julian said, I only need $10,500 to buy that $300,000 home. I'm going to do that instead, rather than try to pay off my student loans aggressively. And I'm going to acquire the asset that then has cash flow. So the person who then pays off their student debt in 2 years because they are being aggressive, guess what? Now, 2 years later, they're debt free, right? But now when they want to go buy 2 years later, they want to go buy the same home that the other person bought 2 years earlier. Guess how much that home costs? Instead of costing $300,000, it now costs $340,000. Why? Because it appreciated. So all that debt that they paid off, they're now paying it as extra on the house that they're now buying. It's the same house, but because it's 2 years later and it appreciated, they have to pay more. They have to pay $40,000 more. It would have just made more sense for them to go acquire the property instead of trying to aggressively pay off their student debt. Multifamily mindset. You got to think about debt and money differently, y'all. I'm trying to give you the game, okay? So what does it mean to buy right? Buying right means that you buy, that the property gives you cash flow, that at least it puts you at rent and mortgage freedom and hopefully more, and that there's built-in equity the moment you buy the home, that you found a home that is undervalued and it has built-in equity, the home has definite appreciation potential, and the deal positions you to acquire your dream home free and clear and secures your retirement and adds to your legacy, okay? So there's a lot of people out there online selling you these pipe dreams, right? And everybody's promising you that you can become a millionaire. I have factual evidence that if you follow the blueprint that I'm going to show you, you'll be a millionaire. It's going to take some time, but I can show you exactly how it will occur, right? So you stop chasing these rabbits, right? Trying to catch all these rabbits and ending up with none. Multi-level marketing, cryptocurrency, this and that, that and this. Just stop. It's probably so hard for you because it's just in plain sight. You're driving, you're in real estate right now. You work in real estate. You gave birth in real estate. You make love in real estate. You buy your groceries in real estate. You sleep in real estate. It's so in plain sight that I think it's hard for you to believe that this could be the path, but it is. And I'm a living example of that, okay? Multifamily real estate is the most proven business model of all time. There's no other business model that has transcended it, okay? These tech stocks, et cetera, they go up and they go down. The stock market will go up and it will go down, okay? Well, who are you to guess right? In fact, stock market is a whole bunch of roulette. I mean, you'd actually be better off at the roulette table because even at the roulette table, you know that your chances of betting all on black is 49%. At the roulette table, at least you know that. The stock market, you have no clue, right? You don't know what that CEO is going to do. You don't know if that company is actually playing with his number to try to show profitability just so the CEO can get a bonus. You don't know the true value. There's no correlation between the value of a company and stock price in today's market. There used to be, not in today's market. So one of the most valuable things on earth is actually a piece of earth. And as the original man and woman of this planet, right, you deserve to have a piece of this earth. We have to take back ownership because our other brothers and sisters who walk in the face of the earth, they're not treating Mother Earth the way that she meant to be treated. And this is why we have the storms and the things that we have, right? Because they aren't taking care of Mother Earth. We have to go take the land back, okay? So I can guarantee you millions over time. I can guarantee it because watch this. That $300,000 home that I've been showing you over and over and over again, here's the value of it. Because when you buy multifamily real estate, there's four benefits. There's a cash flow, there's a tax savings, there's a principal pay down by the tenants, and there's appreciation. So watch this. 30 years from now, look what this home does for my family. It's going to produce $638,000 in cash flow for me. That's $638,000 in my pocket over 30 years. The tax savings, because I get to depreciate this property over 27.5 years, is going to be $278,000 in tax savings. Money that I did not send to the government, $250,000 in tax savings. The principal pay down, because I had to pay 25% in as a down payment because I'm an investor, right? It's gonna be $225,000 paid by the tenants, not by me, okay? So they're paying down my debt. And then the appreciation at 1% per year over the next 30 years would be make this house worth $404,000. When you add all those things up, this one single decision that I made is going to create $1.2 million in generational wealth that I get to pass on to my daughter. Now, if you invested that same amount of money into the stock market, you would have $500,000 at $503,000, which is great, but it's not $1.2 million. So this is the power of multifamily real estate. It's not just the cash flow. It's the tax savings, it's the principal pay down, and it's the appreciation over time, okay? So everybody's out there talking about secure the bag. Yeah, secure the bag by securing a building. Go secure a building and you will secure the bag. And that will secure your housing, it will secure your retirement, and it will secure your legacy, all right? So with that, I want to say thank you so much. I hope that this presentation blessed you and gave you the game. You know, earlier we asked for permission to share an opportunity with you that we think can help you actually activate this and get this done. And so if you are open to hearing the opportunity that we have, go ahead and type yes in chat. Go ahead and type yes in chat. For those of you who are not interested whatsoever, we sincerely from the bottom of our hearts hope that this presentation blessed you. Go out and try to execute and make it happen. Go find a deal, go make an offer, go analyze that deal and get it done. We would love to see your success, whether you do it with us or not. But we know that we can save you a lot of time, we can save you a lot of mistakes, and we can help you win a lot faster, safer, and easier than you trying to go out and do it on your own. All right. So real quick, what was your greatest takeaway tonight so far? What was your greatest takeaway? Greatest insight? Funding opportunities. Okay. The passive, that I'm homeless. Got to change your mind. The death pledge. I'm dumb as hell. No, you're not. You just, and there's a difference between being dumb and being ignorant. Ignorant just means you didn't know. Okay. That I can't afford it. That I need more roaches in my life. Yep. That I need an asset, passive income. That I'm homeless. That I'm homeless. I'm glad that one resonated, y'all. Because we can't just sit here thinking we're comfortable. We train in our subconscious minds that we're safe, and we're not. We're not, okay? So with that, I know that here's the deal, okay? I know that if you're like me, I know that you're here because you want more generational wealth, you want passive income, you want more freedom, and I know that because that was me too. I was in the exact same boat. But I also know that anybody can, with a decent credit score and some savings and a decent income, you can go buy real estate. You can go read Rich Dad, Poor Dad, and you can go find a real estate agent, and they can send you some deals and you can make an offer. I know you can do all that. But the question is, not everyone will buy right. Not everybody will buy real estate right. This is why people get foreclosed on, because they didn't buy right. Okay. So I want to help you find a cash flow positive property that has definite appreciation, a built-in equity, definite appreciation potential that's going to create generational wealth and leave a legacy for your family that you get to pass down. Now, my expertise is in one specific area. There's all kinds of ways to make money in real estate. Apartment buildings, real estate agent, industrial, mobile homes, tax liens, wholesaling, new construction, property management, foreclosures, vacation rentals, fix and flip, multifamily, and commercial. There's all kinds of ways to make money in real estate. The one that I have expertise in and have proven track record in is multifamily. I do not teach fix and flips. I do not teach wholesaling. What I actually teach is multifamily real estate, how to buy a multifamily property that is pretty much turnkey and is going to cash flow for you immediately. For those of you who came late, I showed you my portfolio. These are my actual properties. I have control over all of these. I don't own them, right? Because they're still a mortgage, but I have control over all these. I benefit from all of the appreciation and all of the cash flow from every single property that you see here. It's 27 doors, 11.4% cash on cash return, 30% appreciation, $285,000 in rental revenue every single month. I can't wait until the first of the month, y'all. I can't wait. Most people dread the first of the month. I can't wait till the first of the month, okay? And together, that portfolio has $3.6 million in value. So how I can show you how to do this is through a program that I've created called the Multifamily Master Plan. And it's a 12-week experience where I'll work through with you with everything we discussed and a lot more to accelerate how quickly you're able to buy a multifamily home the right way. They give you rent freedom for those of you who are renting or positive cash flow if you have other debts like a single family home, right? Student loans, credit cards, medical bills, et cetera, all right? Now, the way this program is structured, it has five modules, which is one, finance it, find it, finalize it, fix it, and fill it. Okay, so I guide you step by step through the process. Now, this program is for you if you're an entrepreneur employee where you make decent money and you want to stop paying rent forever and use that new revenue to pay off your student loans. If you are a side hustler who's ready to quit, but you know you need to buy a multifamily home before you quit because it's easier to get financed if you do it while you have W-2 income. Okay, if you're a single family homeowner and you realize that you've actually backed yourself into a tough situation, I'm going to show you how to get out of that situation, okay? How to eliminate your mortgage through rental income from another property and still leverage FHA. I'm going to show you how to do that. If you're a committed couple, I actually have a way for you to double the amount of wealth you two create if you're a committed couple that's not yet married and hasn't filed taxes together, right? So I want to show you exactly these strategies so that you can double the wealth that you're able to, in the financial strength and the financial foundation of your family. And if you're an experienced entrepreneur who's actually been making decent income for the past 3 years, I want to show you how to buy multifamily real estate despite not having traditional W-2 income, okay? So module one, finance it. I'm going to show you no to low money down programs and grants you can use to get started without a huge savings. What exactly your lender is looking for, the key numbers and ratios you need to be aware of. Quick credit fixes to improve your credit score and keep your interest rates down and save tens of thousands of dollars. Literally a 0.125% change in your interest rate will save you over $10,000 over the life of your loan. FHA loans debunk the dark side that most people don't tell beyond it being just a 3.5% down program. Why you must shop for lenders first, not the home. A lot of you go to Trulia and Zillow, start shopping for home. You need to shop for a lender first, okay? And how to get the lowest interest rate possible by doing so. Why you should go as big as possible on your first multifamily home, as long as it makes sense, okay? And then opportunity zones. I'm sure some of you heard about them, how you can actually leverage them and the tax advantages that they offer. Module two, find it. How to find great deals in your backyard, literally. I told you that my first deal, it literally was in my backyard. My apartment in Brooklyn was adjacent. It shares a backyard with the property I now own, okay? So there's deals literally right around you. How to use the internet and the specific websites you need to know to find and do due diligence on a deal. How to evaluate a deal in another state if you're investing from a distance. Why the asking price does not matter and the real metrics that make a deal worth it or not. And the people and tools you need in place to get deals coming to you daily, okay? Finalize it. The 23 numbers you need to truly evaluate whether to purchase or pass on a real estate opportunity, like I showed you in the purchase or pass deal analyzer. How to quickly evaluate a deal in 10 minutes or less so that you can get your offer in before anyone else. Remember, the only thing that beats a cash offer is a fast offer. The four most overlooked numbers that can make or break a deal. How to never pay at or above asking price and get it reduced to whatever you desire without worrying about the seller walking away. And the five ways to exit any deal if the numbers aren't adding up or something doesn't feel right, okay? And then fix it. 10 types of contractors you need to have and trust in and on speed dial once a deal is in motion. How to vet your team beyond using Yelp or Angie's List, the questions you need to ask and the things to look for. Walk, crawl, climb, everything you must do and look for during the property inspection process. First things first, what are the very first things you need to do once you have the keys? Hint, it is not move in. Fix it or nix it, what you should fix immediately and what can wait for later once you start cash flowing, okay? Then finally, fill it. Your landlord now. Now what? How do you immediately lay the new ground rules with existing tenants, especially the ones who don't align with how you desire to live? How to find great tenants fast if you have vacant units that need to be filled, what you need, who you need, and where to post. And free download, I'll give you a free download of my sample lease agreement. And then long distance investing secrets, how to manage your investments without actually being there, okay? So that is the program. I've had several people go through this program who have coached through this process. This is the Royal family, and this is what they said. Julian's journey has always been an inspiration to my wife and I. We didn't think we were ready, but Julian helped us see that we were. Now we own a fourplex in Los Angeles that has already appreciated and generates enough cash flow for my wife and I to both step into entrepreneurship full-time while still being financially responsible parents of our one-year-old daughter, Jubilee, okay? The Campbells. My issue was that I had a rental property that wasn't cash flowing because I didn't buy right, as Julian always says. Thanks to the coaching, we came up with a strategy to sell the property and leverage it into a multifamily unit using a 1031 exchange. We found a real estate attorney to transfer the rental property out of my name and into the LLC. Now that we've corrected our real estate wrongs and have a cash flowing Airbnb in Charlotte, which Julian taught me how to scale quickly, and a multifamily where we live mortgage-free in one of the two units, okay? So these are real life examples of Black families who I've freed through the multifamily master plan. So this plan would typically cost $1,999 per year, okay? But tonight I'm gonna show you how you can get access to the multifamily master plan for 100% free. How many of you down for that? How many of you would like the multifamily master plan for 100% free? I'm gonna show you how you can get it for free, okay? I repeat, it's all free. Now you're probably wondering, what's the catch, okay? Julian, what's the catch? All you have to do to get access to the multifamily master plan for free is join the Black Real Estate Investor Group, which is committed to creating freedom and generational wealth through real estate. Our mission at the Black Business School is to help free 300 families and people to acquire cash flow positive multifamily real estate within 6 months of being pre-approved. Okay. So the way this works is that you have to join the mastermind in order to get access to the multifamily master plan for free. Similar to a gym, you have to have the gym membership to get access to the equipment. At the Black Business School and at the Freedom School, Dr. Watkins and I have been teaching online for over a decade now. And what we've come to recognize is that we can no longer give our information, our gold away for free without providing people with the accountability to actually implement the information. Because the only way we get free as a people is actually through the implementation of this information. There's all kinds of free information on the internet, but people still aren't transforming. We're not just here for the transfer of information. We are here for your transformation. And so we have created a community, and a system of accountability that will make sure that you actually implement the information that we're sharing with you. So we no longer give away our gold for free. You have to, we only give it to people who are committed to implementing the information. Does that make sense? Okay. So I want to be clear. We're not just going to give you the multifamily master plan. The only way you get it is if you go through the program of accountability and the community that we provide for you that actually makes sure that you implement the information. We do not want to waste our time just giving information and no transformation occurring. Nobody wins that way. Okay. So this is how we are moving as online educators today with integrity. Okay. So you get the multifamily master plan course, you'll get access to that. And then I also want you to know that this is not a course. Some of you bought courses before, and this is not a course. Okay. Only 20% of this program will actually be on the computer. Yes, there are videos that I put out that you will have to watch on a weekly basis. Right. But this is experiential learning. You cannot learn real estate by watching videos on YouTube, by listening to podcasts and reading books. Okay. Because if that was the case, then everybody who read Rich Dad, Poor Dad will be in real estate right now. Okay. This program is 20% on the computer, 40% on the phone, talking to agents, investors, to owners, to sellers, to contractors, to wholesalers. You will be on the phone 40% of the time, and 40% of this program, you will be in your car, on foot, or on your bike, going out and experiencing new neighborhoods. 80% of this program is experiential. Only 20% is on the computer, okay? Real estate is a contact sport. You have to be in contact with people and be in contact with properties. That's the only way that you can win in real estate. We cannot just set you up with a whole bunch of videos and all of a sudden the deal falls in your lap. It does not work that way. Okay. So how this works is every week you will get a brand new challenge. The first week is the financial house cleaning challenge. Then there's a lender shopping challenge. Then there's a pre-approval challenge. Then there's a real estate agent challenge. And I guide you step by step how to complete each challenge. And every challenge you complete is going to move you closer and closer to landing your first cash flow positive multifamily real estate deal. So every week for the 12 weeks, you will be having a challenge to do. This will be experiential. You won't just be sitting back watching a video like this and thinking that you are now in the game of real estate. The game of real estate is out there. It's outside. It is not on your computer. Okay. So this is how we structure the program. On top of that, to hold you accountable, we have our weekly deal room calls. Every Sunday, we meet together as a group. And you can bring your questions, your deals, your challenges with your multifamily map, your multifamily math, or your multifamily mindset. I will coach you through those challenges in the context of our community. And when I'm coaching you or I'm coaching somebody else, everybody is being coached because everybody is going through the exact same thing. So these weekly deal room calls, they're worth, there's 50 of them over the course of the year, and they are worth a lot. They're worth $2,399, okay? On top of that, you will all get access to the Purchaser Pass Deal Analyzer so that you can evaluate deals the way I do, okay? I've spent over 2 years building out this model, and it will be yours for absolutely free when you join the multifamily, when you join the Black Real Estate Investor Group, okay? What did I say before? The only thing that beats a cash offer is a fast offer, and all you do is plug in the numbers into the orange cells, and I'm going to show you how to find every one of those numbers, and over here in the lower right, it will say, purchase this or don't purchase this. Okay. It's as simple as that. Okay. On top of that, we are inviting you to New Orleans in January for a 2-day wealth and real estate summit led by Dr. Watkins and I. You get one free ticket to that event. You get to come down here, eat some good seafood, enjoy this weather, especially those of you who are in the Northeast, right? And also, we're going to work hard. We're going to play hard. We're going to go to Frenchman Street. We're going to go to Bourbon Street. We're going to have fun in the evenings. But during the day, we're going to be getting it in, okay? It's going to be a great, great time. We had an event here, a different event here a few months ago, and it was absolutely amazing. So you're going to get one free ticket to come here. All you have to do is get your butt here, pay for your food, and pay for your hotel. The event is absolutely free for you. This is going to be a $599 ticket for any outsiders, okay? So when you add all that together, the multifamily master plan, the 50 weeks of deal room calls, and the live event in New Orleans, that's $4,997. But I got something else for you. There's a few bonuses. The first bonus is the Fuel It module. And this is how to scale from 1 to 10. When you're in this journey, there's three challenges, 0 to 1, 1 to 2, and then 2 to 10. And I'm going to show you exactly how I built my entire portfolio, how I used deal number 1 to buy deal number 7, how I used deal number 2 to buy deal number 9. I'm going to show you how to start building momentum in your portfolio, okay? So this is the Fuel It module, and I'm going to show you how to scale and grow up beyond just one property, because I want you all to have more than one property. It's not just, we're going to get you that one, right? But I want you to have more than one. The next is REI Tax Secrets, how to reduce your taxes. Remember I showed you on that $300,000 home that I was going to have $278,000 in tax savings as a result of owning that home, which you don't get with a single family home. I'm going to show you how to set up your tax structure and what you need to send to your accountant to make sure that you get all of those tax write-offs. We use everything in the tax code. This is not tax evasion. Tax evasion is illegal. This is tax avoidance by leveraging the law. Okay. And I'm going to show you exactly how to do that to maximize how much you can deduct. Okay. Then there's overnight success, how to grow using Airbnb. I've grown a six-figure Airbnb business with just one of my properties. With just one of my properties, I had a six-figure Airbnb business. So people say there's no such thing as an overnight success. Well, guess what? Airbnb is overnight success. I got people sleeping overnight, and I'm successful because of it. Airbnb is the closest thing you're going to get to overnight success, okay? So I'm going to show you exactly how to use Airbnb if it is legal in the city that you are in, okay? Now, the Purchaser Pass Deal Analyzer, it is being turned into an online app, and you will get lifetime access to that once it becomes an online app, okay? And so that is being developed right now. I was able to test it out this week, and you will get lifetime access to that so that you can evaluate all your deals in one place, okay? So when you add in all the bonuses, this total package would be worth $7,287. Here's everything that it includes. It includes the multifamily master plan, the weekly deal room call, the purchase pass deal analyzer, the two-day event, Fuel It module, real estate tax secrets, and overnight success Airbnb course. But again, you will not be paying $7,287 today, even though it would be worth it. So quick question to you. Would it be worth $7,287 one time to eliminate your monthly rent expense or single family home mortgage forever? How many would pay $7,287 to eliminate your rent expense or your single family mortgage forever? How many would do that one time? All right. This is the education I'm going to get you. What did I say? Your intellectual property can actually turn into physical property. Your intellectual property, what you know, can turn into physical property if you get the right intellectual property. Okay. What if all this did was help you acquire one cash flow positive multifamily home within the next year? Would this be worth it? Would this be worth it? You're going to pay your agent, you're going to pay your real estate agent more than you pay this on the deal you acquire, right? But without this information, you may never acquire a deal, okay? And then would it be worth it if the only thing you learned was how to buy right so that you never ended up underwater on a real estate deal thanks to the deal analyzer? If that purchaser pass deal analyzer just saved you from not going into a bad deal that you end up stuck in and have to sell for less than the debt you have, right? Would that be worth it? Okay. So we have a 30-day money-back guarantee. We want you to come in and try it. We want you to come in and try it and see if it actually works for you. This is the Black Business School's guarantee. If you enroll and are unhappy for any reason, you simply email support@theblackbusinessschool.com. No explanation needed. However, we will welcome your feedback so that we can make the experience even better. Okay. Even better. So we want to invite you to come test this out. If you are on the fence right now, come test it out. And we'll give you 30 days to kick the tires and see if it's for you. Test us out. Okay. And once you are pre-approved, I personally take responsibility for your success as long as you show up and do the work, which means that you're pounding the pavement, meeting people, analyzing deals, and making offers. I will see you through to the finish line. Okay. So the entire offer is worth $7,287. You won't be paying that today. Okay. In fact, today you can join the Black REI group for just $2,499, literally about one third of that entire price. So option number one, it feels free, but it will cost you the most, and that's you doing nothing. Okay, it's you doing nothing, continuing to rent and just hope that something changes, that a multifamily deal falls into your lap. And while you're renting, guess what? The price of rents are going to continue to rise, which is going to make it harder for you to save. And then the prices of real estate are going to continue to rise, which will make it harder for you to buy. Okay. So if you are ready to make this move right now, literally this one decision could change the financial trajectory of your life and actually guarantee that you leave generational wealth for your family. Then go to theblackreigroup.com. Theblackreigroup.com. Okay. Theblackreigroup.com to join. That is the website. Okay. And if you join at the annual payment, you will save $1,089. This is $2,499 per year, but you will save $1,089 per year by paying in full, by diving in, not just putting your big toe in, right? But by diving in and saying, Julian, I'm committed to this journey. I'm committed to this result in my life. Literally, based on the rents that you put out for you all, that's 1 to 2 months of rent. I'm asking you for 1 to 2 months of rent to never, ever have to pay rent again. That is the opportunity that's at hand. Now, for those of you who don't have $2,499 right now, one, that's a red flag. That means that what you've been doing is actually not working, okay? And that it's time to do something different. But we care for you and we want to see you win. And so we have another option, which is you can get started for as low as $299 per month. $299 per month. Okay. Again, go to theblackreigroup.com, theblackreigroup.com if you want to join on the monthly payment plan. Okay. When you go to theblackreigroup.com, you will see this down here at the bottom, and you want to select which plan is best for you. Okay. And then enroll in the course. Right. You'll automatically be logged into the course. You'll have access to the modules. Okay. And we have our call on Sunday. So you want to get started now, go in there, get the orientation, right? And get it going. So $299 a month, that's what, $997 a day. We had to make this low enough to be affordable, but high enough to keep out those who aren't really serious. And we don't have time to play around with people who are not serious, who want things for nothing. You're not going to get real estate for nothing. So why would we train you to get a course in this program for nothing? It doesn't work that way, right? You reap what you sow. You have to sow in to reap. And so this is your opportunity to sow into your own mind, right? So I can retrain you in terms of how to think about and how to grow wealth. Literally, all of you here tonight are one deal away. This is my first deal. You're one deal away from changing everything. I had no intentions of being a real estate investor. I knew that I wanted at least one property, and I got that one. But once I saw the power of it, I couldn't help but buy more, okay? And so this is what I want for you, not just one, but you are just one deal away. Many people have bought Rich Dad Poor Dad. I won't say many people have read it. Many people have bought Rich Dad Poor Dad, okay? Over 40 million people. But how many of those 40 million people have actually read it? How many people just bought it and it's just sitting on their shelf and they've done nothing? And then on top of that, if let's say 10 million people have read it, how many people have actually taken action on the contents of the book? Not that many, not that many. So please don't be this guy who is reading about fasting but stuffing his face with food. This is why we don't just give our gold, our information away for free. People can get information overload all day long, but never take action. The only way transformation occurs is through the implementation and integration of the information, okay? So the first deal matters so much because one, the leverage it offers. It's the only time that you're gonna be able to get 3.5% down, okay? So this is why the leverage is so important. Then once you win on that first deal, the confidence that it gives you from winning early to go to deal number 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then the cash flow that leads to rent freedom or mortgage freedom. Once you achieve that, oh my goodness, you will, the stress that's in your shoulders, wherever you hold your stress, that is just going to evaporate. It's just going to go away. And then the options to refinance and acquire deal number 2 is why this is so powerful, okay? So again, go to theblackreigroup.com. Now there is a price to procrastination. Today, it is $299 per month or $249 per year. If you procrastinate, it will jump to $499 per month or $3,999 per year. And when the price does jump, there will be no free bonuses, which are together worth $2,290. Okay, so you want to take advantage of this now. You have to know the difference between what is expensive and what is expansive. An expense is money that leaves forever and never returns to you. And a lot of you have a lot of expenses. If I looked at your bank statement right now, all I would see is expenses, 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 expenses. No assets. An investment is money that leaves and it returns with more friends. Okay. Remember, Puff said, you tell your friends to get with my friends and we can be friends. That's what an investment is. Okay. Right. That's what an investment is when you think about money going out into the world, you releasing the money, it going out to the world and it bringing you back more and itself, it coming back with more friends. Every dollar you should spend in your life should be an investment in some way. So right now, are you thinking this is expensive? I can't afford to do this right now. Or are you thinking it's expansive? I can't afford not to do this right now. And how do you want to think? How do you want to feel? What do you want to believe? Okay. So go to theblackreigroup.com. It should be in the chat. Lawrence and the team should be putting it in the chat for you. Okay. So again, you can start for $2,499 tonight, and that'll be fully committed and me supporting you every step of the way for an entire year, okay? Or you can join for just $299 tonight. You can get access to everything for $299 tonight, but I want you to know that those of you who are on the monthly plan, your modules will be dripped to you, okay? So they will come out at a slower pace than those who fully commit, all right? Again, this is my portfolio. This is what's possible. And I did this in 6 years, 2013 to 2019. I just acquired these two literally in the past month, right? And so in 6 years, I've been able to build this. This is how quickly it can happen, y'all. I'm actually at my Fannie Mae maximum of 10 mortgages. Fannie Mae, she got a limits, y'all, and she won't give me any more. So that means what I'm doing now is I'm actually finding deals here in New Orleans and I'm passing them off to the group. Literally, I posted a deal in the group the other day, right? I'm passing it off to the group so that you all can win. And this is how I pass them off. First and foremost, the people who pay annually in the order that they join, that's who gets to see the deals first. And then after that, if nobody moves on it, then I pass it to the people who pay monthly in the order that they actually join. So when you join and how quickly you join is actually important to this process, okay? So we do have a fast action bonus for those of you who join by 10 p.m. Eastern, right? Within the next 15 minutes, we will give you an extra ticket for your significant other or your business partner or your mom, whoever you're going to be investing with, we'll give you an extra ticket to the event in New Orleans for January, okay? That's $599 worth of value if you take action, if you just stop procrastinating, stop hesitating. You have to know that hesitation is the opposite of happiness, okay? Happiness is going after what you want. Hesitation is not going after what you want. So stop hesitating if you want to be happy, okay? You have to make a move. You have to make a decision. And you know that the decisions that you've been making, especially in regards to your housing, haven't been the best ones, right? So it's time to make a decision in the complete opposite direction. And it's going to have to be a radical decision for a lot of you because the momentum that you have going, paying rent for 9 years, right? $129,000, paying $1,200 rent to a slumlord. Like, how do we get okay with that? How can we be okay with that when we know we have seeds who are looking to us to be our example, right? We can't. We have to make a move. So here's what's going to happen when you join. You get onboarded. You get your deal analyzer. You'll start the online course. You'll go through orientation. We have our weekly deal room call on Sunday, and you'll start your first challenge. And everybody will have their own pace. Some of you are going to be on pace to move at, and get it done in 12 weeks. Some of you know that it's busy season for you on the corporate plantation and they're whipping you hard and it's going to take you 24 months to get through the entire thing. That's okay. To each his own. You know what you got going on in your life right now. Okay. So again, you can get all of this for just $299 tonight. So take advantage of it. Make a move. For those of you who are waiting on the down payment and persistence program by state, those will come to you via email. So just hold tight. We are going to send an email to everyone out there. Okay. We're going to send an email to everyone out there. So with that, I want to bring Dr. Watkins and Lawrence back on. We're going to take all your questions. The way that we field questions, Lawrence is fielding them. You want to use the Q&A tab below. You want to use the Q&A tab below and your question will be put in queue. And we're going to go through as many questions as we can. There's a lot of questions right now. So it's not that we're not seeing your question, it's that there's a lot of questions and we want you to make an informed decision going forward. I hope that I made the argument that multifamily real estate is a guaranteed path to you being a millionaire and creating generational wealth. If you have a different argument, I would love to hear it. But I think we made our case and we would like to invite you to support you and going on this journey. I know that I can get you there faster, safer, and easier than you can get there on your own. And I want you to avoid every single mistake that I made along the way, which will save you money and actually create more wealth for you. So with that, I'm happy to have the fellas come back on and let's field these questions before 10 o'clock.
All right. So just a couple things. So one, how's everyone doing tonight? I don't think I popped on at the beginning of tonight's webinar. My name is Lawrence Watkins. I am the president and chief operating officer of the Black Business School. So we've partnered with Julian to bring you this amazing program that many people have already started and are getting a lot of benefit out of as well. So there's really no reason to even hesitate. Please make sure if you have questions tonight, please put them in the Q&A section and not in chat. So put them in the Q&A section and not in chat, because chat moves way too quickly for me to look at and view. So please do that. Also, when it comes to the price, because this question has come up a lot already, it is for tonight's offer. Well, you know, the offer for it goes through the weekend. So it's going to close at 11:59 on Sunday night, right? So at the end of the weekend on Eastern time, it's going to close at that time. This offer will no longer be available right now. So there's two plans. You can either do $299 per month or $2,499 per year. That is $299 per month or $2,499 per year. There is no lifetime access to this particular program because it costs us money every single month to run this program with our time and our energy and that type of thing as well, because that's the question we get a lot. And we just want to be very, very, very clear, when you are going through this process, that there's either a monthly option or a yearly option. All right. So with that being said, all right, let's see here. All right. Yep. So Julian, what time are the calls on Sunday night?
They are 8 p.m. Eastern and they are all recorded. So if you can't make it on a particular Sunday night, they're all recorded, uploaded by Monday morning. So you can listen to it during your commute.
All right. Let's see. Now, does this course work for someone mentioned that they were incarcerated? And they're worried that they're not going to be able to get loans and that type of thing. Does this program work for individuals like that too?
I don't know what incarceration has to do. They base it on your income, your credit score. Okay, your income, which is actually your revenues, and your credit score. So those are the primary two drivers of your their decision to finance you at a certain level. Whether you're incarcerated, if you have income and you have a decent credit score, then you can get financed, right? So incarceration has nothing to do with it. Now, if you have bankruptcy or foreclosure, there are some timelines that they have before being able to get another mortgage, but incarceration doesn't have that. They're not even going to ask you if you've been incarcerated.
All right. Congratulations to Wally. He just said in chat that he just joined. He's excited to get started.
And Wally has 80,000 in equity. So Wally, we're going to show you how to leverage that equity, right? Without feeling over leveraged to actually acquire property that actually then not only puts that equity back into your pocket. So that's beautiful, and that's going to give you a leg up. So excited to see that.
All right, let's see here. We had a few more people join. That was quick. That was quick.
Okay.
We had five people join in like a minute over here. So congrats, Tracy. Congrats, Wally, of course, Catherine, Bonita, and Mervin. Thank you guys, and congratulations on joining the Multifamily Mastermind. I have no doubt in my mind, and I'm sure Julian feels the same way, that this program is going to be life-changing, as real estate is one of the best ways to generate generational wealth for you and your family. So congratulations for already, being a part of this program. So, all right. Let's see. What is the minimum credit scores needed to obtain mortgage financing in today's banking lending climate?
Yeah, FHA is 580 to get the 3.5% down. It's 500. If you have 500 to 579, it'll be 10% down. So it's only 580 for FHA, which is pretty low.
All right. How do I find the best market to invest in for multifamily properties, cities?
Yeah, so we have a market analyzer that I train you in how to use and how to use from a distance. Because many of you, when you're going into another market, you're likely initially start reviewing it from a distance. But some of the markets that you will likely end up investing in are markets that you've been to, you visited for work or for vacation, and there was something that gravitated, that pulled you there, right? For me, that's what happened with New Orleans. And then I'd come here enough times and I was like, I love it here and I would live here. I'm not saying that you have to live in the market that you invest in, but the market will probably have grabbed you in some way. You probably won't make a market decision just based on statistics, right? It's going to be have to be something there that draws you. I also encourage people in the movement to actually go back. If they're from a small town, like I got homies in Arkansas who are buying up a small town in Arkansas, right? Like go buy back your block. Like literally go buy it back. Take this city income that you're making and go take it to the South or go take it to where you grew up and go buy back that community. And that's been a powerful strategy for people. So, yeah.
All right. So, someone asked, as a real estate investor, do I need a real estate agent and or a real estate advisor?
You need both. I'm going to be your advisor, but you're still going to need an agent in your market in order to execute in terms of submitting the offer, right? Your property inspection response, all that stuff. That's what the agent is licensed to do. But I'm going to be your advisor to make sure that you're actually making the best deal from a multifamily investment strategy. So I'm going to serve as your advisor. So you need both.
All right. James wants to know, how do the challenges relate to the modules released weekly with the monthly plan?
They're directly related. So the modules are mindset, and then the challenges are the actual experiential. So I'm going to change your mindset on how to approach lenders. So I'll give you an example. You think that the lender is approving you, but you're actually approving them. You're approving the lender, right? They're going to make probably $250,000 in interest off of you, right? So they should be fighting for your business without doing much. Without doing much except sending you a mail notice saying that you in an envelope to pay them. So you actually want to make them fight for you, not you fighting for them. So we do that mindset stuff first. That's what the 20% videos are for. But then afterwards is you going and actually making them fight for you. So that's where the experiential, you're going to be talking to various lenders and I give you all the questions and things that you need to do in order to create a bidding war literally between them for you.
All right. Here we go. Hold on. I answered this already, Valerie, but is this lifetime or annual, or is it part annual and part lifetime? So there is no lifetime membership for this program, Valerie. So there's only monthly and yearly. So you can either pay monthly or yearly. There is no lifetime membership for the Black Real Estate Investor Group.
Yep. The only thing that's lifetime is for joining. I'm going to give you lifetime access to the Purchaser Pass Deal Analyzer. But beyond that, it is a monthly program. And if, it's a monthly program or annual. Yes.
All right. Rashonda wants to know, is this offer available indefinitely?
Oh, no, it ends on Sunday. And we actually encourage you to join by Saturday. We by Sunday morning because we have our weekly deal room call on Sunday. So we though the offer goes until Sunday night, we encourage you to join by Sunday morning so that you can be on. You don't miss this week's deal room call.
All right. And Bonita, I saw your question in the Zoom chat. Congratulations on joining. If you can send me over the correct email address for your account, I can go ahead and get that changed. You can just send it to all panelists. And only me and Julian will see your email address. All right. Let's see here. If you guys have any questions specifically related to the offer, we're going to try to get through those first, just for individuals who are having questions before they make their buying decision.
People trying to get coaching in the Q&A.
Yeah, you know, they got the expert here. I don't blame them. Shoot, if I had a Julian Gordon waiting for me, answer my questions, you know.
That's what the deal room is. But that's what the Sunday night deal room is for, yo. That's where those kind of questions get answered. Okay. So I just want to be clear.
All right. This is okay. So someone asked, in a single family home, they require you to live in it for a certain amount of time. Is this true for a multifamily unit as well?
FHA loan, yes. You're required to live in it for a year. There's a 1 year living requirement. Yes.
All right. So Kat wants to know, what if you are a real estate agent already looking to invest using your program?
Again, most real estate agents don't think like real estate investors. Most real estate agents don't have multifamily properties or aren't able to calculate cash on cash returns. So I teach you how to think like a real estate investor, not just a real estate agent, right? So we already have agents who are in here, because most real estate agents, after being in the game, they're like, wait a second, I'm helping all these other people build wealth. Why don't I take this access that I have to these deals first and these relationships? And why don't I build wealth? Why don't I keep some of these things for myself? So, I'm going to show you how to think like that. And you have an advantage because you're in it. But it's kind of like a bank teller. Like, it's like a bank teller who is around money all day, but they're still broke, right? They're seeing people who look like college kids come in and deposit six figures. And yet they are still broke. And so just being around it doesn't mean that you truly understand it. And so I'll teach you the depths of it so that you can truly understand it. And given the access you have as an agent, that's actually just going to set you up for even greater success.
All right. ML wants to know, what are the programs that are available by state?
You're going to get that list sent to you via email. Like I said, gotta listen, y'all. Gotta listen.
All right. So T Drew has a question for me. He says, Lawrence, how many multifamily properties do you own? That is an excellent question, T. I don't own any multifamily properties, but there's a couple of reasons for that. One, I actually live in Medellin, Colombia, so South America. And I have a program coming out about, you know, becoming an expat and virtual entrepreneurship soon. But I am definitely going through all the content that Julian is putting out there. And of course, you know, I talk to Julian all the time and we have conversations about this often. And, you know, we're looking to see how we can start doing this, you know, more internationally too, right? So how do we combine, you know, what I'm about to do with the expat stuff, and, you know, foreign real estate investments, and how do you combine that with what Julian already knows as it relates to multifamily real estate, specifically within the United States. So that's something that's percolating in our brains. There's different paths to wealth. And, you know, the more and more I learn about this path in terms of real estate, it's really something I never actually wanted to do. But, you know, Julian is definitely changing my mind, because the argument that he makes as it relates to, you know, why get into this game and not get into others. He makes a very, very compelling argument. And, you know, I'm a believer as well.
Yeah. And, you know, there are so many great deals, you know, in other countries also, you know, and I think, you know, just with what you're doing as an expat in terms of, you know, in our family, I mean, we were pretty much just stuck to the United States. Like, nobody in our family ever did what Lawrence did as far as moving out of the country. And two things you guys did that was really interesting, you and Carla, who's Lawrence's wife. One, they did this thing where they would go live in a different city two or 3 weeks at a time or something like that. And how many cities did you live in during that time?
17. So we went to 17 different cities, and then we eventually chose Medellin, Colombia. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's a different story for a different day. But yeah, we were just out there exploring. But now, you know, how do we, you know, take that exploration and combine it with, you know, what Julian's doing with multifamily real estate? But this program's that first step to make those dreams a reality. So, that's where we stand.
Yeah, what I like about it is that, you know, when you talk about just doing things different, I think that's what we specialize in the Black Business School, is, you know, not so much saying like, okay, do things the way your parents did them, but let's do things that are working. Let's find out what other people are doing and apply these things. So we talk about the expat thing that, and I know in our family, that opened us up to little things that we never did in the previous generation, like family business meetings once a week. You know, we talk about multifamily property ownership, you know, things like that, just really breaking cycles and changing traditions in the family. And that was the point I wanted to go to for sure. And you're right. And once you get out there as well, you find out that the world is much bigger than the United States, that this is literally, you're only being exposed to 2% of what's happening on Earth, pretty much. Right. I mean, you know, you think that this is the world, but this is not the world. This might be your world, but you don't want that to be your world. You know, you talk about getting over oppression and the racism and everything, which occupies our minds, makes us crazy because we're thinking about it all the time. And it's sort of like, no, wait, there's a huge world out there. There's a huge diaspora. There's a lot of places you can go to get power. You can get property. You can change your life. You can live a good life. And so I think that's why. So I think those two are actually connected, actually. For a lot of people, owning rental property or even stepping into that space or entrepreneurship is a lot like, you know, taking on an expat lifestyle where instead of paying, you know, $2,000 a month for rent, you're paying $500 or $600 or $700. And you can afford, you know, a maid and, you know, and all these other things that seem impossible to do in the U.S. So expand your thinking. I think that's the key thing that we've been able to give a lot of our students in the Black Business School.
Yeah, most definitely. And, you know, we have a couple questions in regards to this specific program in terms of how long is the program in full, Julian?
And then, curriculum, it comes out over 12 weeks, but again, some people are going to do it in 12 weeks. Some people are going to do it in six. Some people like have their pre-approval letter. Some people have a pre-approval letter already ready to go. And they're actively looking every single weekend and they're going to find it faster. So everybody's going to have their own timeline, but the curriculum is rolled out over 12 weeks.
All right. And then also, what happens after your first year of membership? Like, so what happens after the year?
Oh, remember, I told you that it's not just about getting one property. So I'm going to help you get from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, right, which is a different hurdle, and then 2 to 10. So I hope to be able to support you along the entire journey. I can help you all the way up to where I am, right? And but a year from now, I'm going to be beyond 10, probably syndicating larger deals, from a 50-unit apartment buildings that some of you will be able to be part of those deals as well. So. Everything that I'm learning, I'm giving back to you.
All right. So, yeah. So to answer that question also, Gina, so once you, yeah. So if, when you join for the yearly program, yes, you have access to everything in the program for that particular year. After that is over, you have the option to renew for another year. If it's still of value to you. So, that's how, you know, the program works. Let's see here. And guys, we have over 100 questions tonight. So I'm trying to answer them as quickly as possible. So I'm trying to answer the questions that directly relate to, you know, what we presented in terms of the offer tonight for those who want to join. And then if we have time left over, I'll be answering, you know, the other questions that you may have, you know, regarding your specific situation. Krista wants to know, currently working on my credit, will this be a problem?
Will it be a problem? No. So basically, there are some people who may not have all the three criteria in place in terms of their income, their savings, and their credit. So what you're going to be doing is simultaneously, you're going to be sharpening your real estate eyes so that you learn how to find real estate deals, and you're going to be building your credit, your savings, et cetera, and so that those things come together at the same time. Otherwise, you spend all this time building your credit, savings, et cetera, and then you want to start learning, and now you actually aren't able to buy until out here. And when you delay buying, what tends to happen? The price goes up of the real estate, right? So you want to be doing those things simultaneously in order to be ready. So the moment that your credit is right, the moment that your savings is there, you're able to move on a deal, not have to wait to now go learn and sharpen your eyes to learn how to find a deal.
All right. So Michael wants to know, congratulations for joining. I just saw your name in the new student enrollees, Michael Hargrove. Congratulations. He asks, we are joining the Black Business School. Does this mean we have access to all of the information in the Black Business School or just the multifamily program? So what you have access to is everything that Julian talked about in the offer today. So that includes, you know, the additional courses that will be coming out, you know, related to the real estate portion. You do not have access to all of the courses in the Black Business School, but, you know, if you, you know, hop on the site and talk to our sales and our customer enrollment specialist team, they can get you in any additional courses that you may need. But I would say just focus on this real estate thing first, because you really don't need a whole bunch of different things to get you to that path, you know, get you to that point of independence and get you to that point of financial freedom. So let's, you know, I would recommend just focus on the real estate portion first, and then we can talk about, you know, all the other cool things that we have within the Black Business School after that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, one at a time.
Tori wants to know, if we get the monthly subscription, do we still get tickets to the New Orleans event?
Yes. As long as your subscription goes through New Orleans event. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep. Yep. And we're looking at January right now for the New Orleans event. Mm-hmm. Right. So, but no, that's not set in stone. So we don't know, you know, what it's going to look like yet, but in terms of the month, but it's looking like it's going to be sometime in the winter time to, you know, get everybody away from the cold. Yeah, the Northeast. All right. Eureka wants to know, how will the monthly option courses be rolled out? My goal is to complete the 12-week challenge. Can I do this in only 3 or 4 months?
Yes, definitely. That is, yes, that you definitely can. So they'll release once a week. 12 modules released once a week.
Someone asked, my credit is bad. Is this program for me?
If your credit is bad, you have to work on your credit. We do encourage you to find a credit repair service, because again, all you have to do is get it up to 580. So you might think it's bad, but if FHA guidelines are actually only require you to have 580 and you're actually already at 550, there might be three things that you paying for a credit repair service can do to get you real estate ready. So yeah, I wouldn't let that stop you.
All right. So Lee wants to know, Julian, will you also be sharing the sites you use to find homes? You mentioned Zillow and Trulia are no good.
Oh yeah. Yeah. But I'll tell you straight up, it's typically not sites. It's actually relationships. It's relationships. So yeah, anything that goes to a website, how many people are looking at that website? Now it becomes a shark tank, right? So it's typically relationships. So Zillow and Trulia are the third place that I go. I'm going to show you the sites that you need to actually properly analyze a deal and do the due diligence, right? There are some other sites to go look at, but it's primarily relationships.
All right. I begin a lot of questions both in Zoom and on YouTube, asking, can we listen to this webinar again?
We typically don't do replays because people don't go to replays. And when people think that something exists for a long time, then they typically don't act on it. Remember, we've been studying behavior of students online for over 10 years. And so this is what we know to be true statistically. People can talk about, oh, no, I'll watch it later. No. Right. But they'll be committed to Game of Thrones. Right. They'll be committed to watching Game of Thrones later. But when it comes to like something that's going to benefit them, no. So the only way we would do a replay right now is if we find that there were technical difficulties. We did get some emails that said people couldn't get in. So we're going to look into that. That's the only way we typically do a replay or encore or anything like that.
Mm-hmm. There is one exception, joining the course. So joining the program, you know, that is the exception in regards to, you know, having access to, you know, what we talked about tonight as well.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Are there any opportunities for military? I used my VA loan for my condo. Would I be eligible for an FHA loan?
I don't believe so. I don't think you can be in two government programs. We'll likely probably have to try to, unless you're emotionally attached to that condo, we probably talk to you about how to leverage up and get out of that condo into something that's actually going to position you for perhaps reacquiring a condo or whatnot going forward. But the single family and condo trap is real, y'all. Like, it's real. It was branded as the American dream, but it actually caught a lot of people up, and it has them stuck. You have people in the chat talking about, you know, can I skip the 1 year living requirement? Is there any way around that? No. So typically you want to buy a multifamily first and then leverage that to get your dream home. But nobody told you that, right? So now you bought this single family home. We have to either figure out how to use the equity to get a multifamily home at 20 to 25% down if you don't want to live in it, or go leverage an FHA loan at 3.5% down, live in it, rent out your single family for a year, and then move back in. Like, there's different strategies. There's 5 different strategies we can use to help you get out of the single family trap.
All right. So someone wants to know, what if you are unemployed because you left corporate America to be an entrepreneur? Will this program still work for me?
They look at you differently. I was an entrepreneur when I got my property, but here's the deal. If you're an entrepreneur, but you're taking cash under the table, you might feel like you're getting paid, but they only account for what's showing up on your tax return. So if you're taking cash payments and you're not actually paying tax on it, they're going to look at what you actually pay tax on. So you think over the past few years, you've been getting away with something, but it's actually hurting you from actually buying real estate. So you're going to have to start reporting your income, and it's going to have to be consistent over a 2 to 3 year period in order to qualify for a mortgage. So typically we encourage those of you who are ready to quit to actually buy your property first. And then the day after you close and get the keys, then you can quit. Okay. Then you can quit. Because it's 10 times easier to buy as a W-2 earner than it is as an entrepreneur, unless you're an entrepreneur who's making over $100,000.
All right. Let's see here. So I want to say congratulations for the people who have just joined in the last few minutes. Mm-hmm. So Paul, Michael, Eureka, hopefully I said that correctly. If I did, we're definitely going to learn how to say your name within the program. Wendy, Karen, Tracy, thank you all for signing up in the last few minutes. All right. Diane wants to know, I want to join, but I don't get paid until the 1st. Can I join then?
I'll leave that to you.
What'd you say, boys?
Well, I was going to say, I don't see why not. If you guys are okay with that, we can make that, you know, that one exception. I think I know you guys wanted to shut the car down quickly and soon.
We're going to shut it down on Sunday, I'm thinking. And then if that is your situation, so if you guys don't get paid until the 1st of the month or something like that, we'll keep the cart open. We'll close the cart. We're going to close the cart, right? And then if you guys need to pay on the 1st of the month or something like that, you need to shoot an email to support@theblackbusinessschool.com. Yeah. That is support@theblackbusinessschool.com with the headline or the title that says, hold my spot, right? My spot, right? And let them know, you know, you don't get paid until the 1st. So hold your spot until the 1st of the month.
I didn't think about it being the end of the month.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah. So the 1st of the month's on the Sunday, it looks like, for September.
Wake up, it's the 1st of the month.
We'll go ahead and hold that till midnight or 11:59 p.m. on August 2nd. But you must send an email to support@theblackbusinessschool.com.
Yeah.
And let me say this, because I've got to walk out of the room, and I'll let you guys, you know, shut us down. But I'll say that the reason that we create programs like this is because, you know, we have a higher degree of accountability when it comes to teaching in the Black community, because we've got a specific problem, which is a specific opportunity for us to do something that's going to resonate over many, many generations after we're gone, the next several hundred years, actually. As what we consider to be the Harvard for Black people, we have designed a unique educational model that's not just disruptive, but it's far more efficient than whatever you might have spent going to college and stuff like that. Mainly because we're teaching you things that are relevant, putting you in a situation where you're going to truly transform. Like Julian said, there's accountability to make sure that it's a transformative experience. Because what we really want is we want you guys to come back as Black Business School alumni. And we want you to put your degree up on your wall when you finish the program. We want you to tell people how great it is. And we want you to consider, you know, letting your relatives know, hey, maybe instead of just sending your child away to go $100,000 in debt so they can learn how to go get a job, you know, try out the Black Business School. You know, maybe they can learn to be a property owner and become a boss. You know, I'm in Atlanta right now, and I'm doing some investment seminars in Atlanta this weekend. And I met some guys today, and we went down to this Chicken and Waffles place, a Black-owned business. And you'd be amazed at what kind of a business school we had just right there in that space. I was talking to the owners of Nana's Chicken and Waffles, and it's a man and his wife, and his wife just finished a cookbook. And I said I would go to her book signing tomorrow. Her cookbook is as nice as Aisha Curry's. You know, I mean, really professionally done. The business is making millions of dollars. And what's also happening in Atlanta is that you have all these people, everything from, you know, celebrities and rappers like T.I. and Killer Mike to billionaire Michael Roberts was here yesterday hanging out with Killer Mike in the hood, talking about buying up dozens and hundreds of buildings in the hood and transformative things in the, you know, that are happening in Black communities. And none of this is happening on the Harvard University campus. None of this is happening at Yale or Stanford or anywhere else. And we know it because we went to schools like that. You know, it's happening right there in your community. So the Black Business School is you. We are in your zone, in your space. We are in that struggle with you. And the beauty of the struggle is that it ain't really a struggle. It's an opportunity for Black greatness and Black excellence. It's an opportunity for Wakanda to be built all over the country. And just what I saw today, you know, I don't even know. I didn't ask one single person I talked to today if they had a degree in business or not, if they went to college or not. Nobody cared. But I do know that the guy sitting across from me, regular brother, him and his wife said, we wanted to have a restaurant. So we bought this old Waffle House, bought some property, flipped it into Nana's Chicken and Waffles, put some Black girl magic on it because his wife is in the kitchen getting those waffles. Now that restaurant is better than all the other restaurants in the area and making millions of dollars on top of it. On the way there, this is real stuff. I'm not making this up. On the way there, I bump into a regular Black man walking down the street. They said, oh, that's Mac. What's going on, Mac? I'm like, who's Mac? Mac's carrying boxes. I'm thinking, I didn't know Mac was. Mac could have been an employee or what? Mac owns, they said, oh yeah, he owns almost, he owns 13 restaurants in the Atlanta Hartsfield Airport. He has three Popeye's chickens, and he's given each of his sons a Popeye's chicken franchise to run as an inheritance. Like, and this man carrying boxes, they said, oh, if you want to get a restaurant in the airport, you got to go through Mac. And so to me, that was beautiful because I'm seeing all these successful Black people. And it's like, it's business school. That's what it is. That's what business school is, learning how to run a business. It ain't reading textbooks or going $100,000 in debt or going to Stanford. Business school for Black folks is happening in hoods all across this country. So, you know, we are kind of your digital hood. The Black Business School, except we don't act hood with it. We're very professional. We're very clear. But everything that we teach you is going to transform your life. And if you don't feel that way, that's why we have our money back guarantee. Universities don't do that. We give you a money back guarantee because we don't want you to go through any of this and not feel like, my gosh, my life is better because I did this. Right. So so what I want you to do, and then I'm going to shut up. I'm going to get on out and let these guys finish up. Look. What I really want is we need to make brand promises to each other. Number one, our promise is that we will deliver for you. We will give you something that is better than anything that you've ever gotten at any university you've ever attended. We will give it to you at 1/100th of the cost that white Americans are charging you for a false education. And what we want from you is this: when you get done, when you complete the program, we want you to print out your Black Business School certificate of achievement, put it on your wall. Maybe get a shirt or something to say, I went to the Black Business School. I'm a graduate of the Black Business School. And we want you also to tell as many friends as you possibly can that the revolution has occurred and is happening right here. And also, you know, tell the world how great your experience was so that we can let folks know that we got to shift direction in order to make this thing work. So I'm out of here, guys. I appreciate all of you, Lawrence and Julie and everybody else. And thank you for letting me get that out. But we really believe in this. This is life's work, life's mission. And how do you know that we're serious? Because we've been doing this stuff day in, day out, every day for over a decade. So y'all know we ain't going nowhere and we ain't no fly by nights. We are here and we're going to be here for the next 500 years. I guarantee it. Thanks a lot, guys.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. Have a good night.
Boom.
All right. Thanks, boys. Thanks. Can you guys hear me? Am I breaking up a little bit, Julian?
You're breaking up now.
Okay.
You're clear now.
All right, cool. So, yeah, those are powerful words, my boys.
Yeah, you breaking up again.
Okay. Let's see. All right. All right, that should be better. There we go. There we go. So someone asked in YouTube, I think this is an important question. Actually, before we get to that question, I just want to reiterate a point that Boyce made, right, in terms of he is so right, and this is a realization that I came to a few years ago. And Julian, you know, he talks about it all the time in his presentations. You know, between the three of us, we have some of the most expensive business degrees that a person could actually have.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. You know what those business degrees mean for us, like with the work that we're doing now? Zero. Nothing. Like, because they don't teach us stuff in business school.
Yeah.
You know, so Julian went to the best business school in the nation, you know, up there with Harvard, right? So Harvard, Stanford, that's basically at Wharton. Those are the three, right? Yeah. But Julian got two degrees from, you know, two master's degrees from Stanford, you know, if we're being completely honest, right? And it means nothing when you talk about doing this real estate stuff. You know, Boyce has a PhD in finance, one of the very few Black people who have that. And that means nothing when it comes to actually building wealth and building a business and building generational legacy for yourself. Mm-hmm. You know, I have a business degree from an Ivy League institution as well. It means nothing with the lifestyle that I currently live. And then it means nothing if I, you know, as I get more and more into real estate internationally and also domestically in the United States. Right. So that means nothing. That means nothing. That means nothing. That means nothing. What we're building with the Black Business School is something that is actually useful and practical for people in our community to start building that freedom and generational wealth that has eluded our community for so long. And that's why we're so excited about this particular program, because it is just a hack of the system, right? You know what I mean? It's like you have all these other companies, you know, that are hacking the system. I was talking about a book that I was reading about the Koch brothers. So Charles and David Koch, and one of the Koch brothers just died today. it was all over New York Times, Wall Street Journal, all that type of stuff. But one thing, as I've been reading their biography and just listening to how they have built such an empire to, you know, move the world in the direction of their philosophy and what they care about for their particular families, is they find these hacks, they find these little loopholes in the system to, you know, exploit, to use, to build generational wealth for their families. So instead of having $1 billion, now they have 10 billion, and then 20 billion, and so on and so forth. This multifamily movement stuff, you know, buying these properties with 2 to 4 doors, that's a hack in the system that we can now use to, you know, build generational wealth. And we're going to continue to find these different hacks all over, but this is one that's available right now. And I have no doubt that Julian is the perfect person to teach all about it. So we hope that you guys join us in terms of what it is that we're doing, because other communities, I mean, they're just exploiting this stuff left and right. You know, right. Multifamily, talking about opportunity zones, talking about just the cannabis industry, talking about all these different things.
Right.
Right. And, you know, it's time for us to start doing the same and building that wealth for our families as well. But yeah, so back to Mr. Mitchell's question. He asked, can I pay 90 days, same as cash, as far as the $2,499? So yes, you can. So you have up to 3 months to upgrade to the yearly plan, right? So if you sign up, you know, today, you have 3 months to upgrade to the yearly plan with no additional cost. So let's say, you know, the third month from now is, you know, day 87, and you decided that you want to, you know, move up to the yearly plan. We will subtract, what's that, $897. So 3 months payment that you've already paid, we would subtract that from the $2,499 that is owed, and then you would pay the difference for the yearly. All right. And also, there's no way that we're going to get to every single question tonight. We're going to, you know, take definitely a few more questions, right? But we're going to have a special session on Sunday night, a Q&A. to answer any questions that haven't been answered tonight, specifically about the offer, right? So questions about the offer, about, you know, what we're talking about, about the Black Real Estate Investor Group, right? In terms of the coaching, we'll try to get some of that done as well. Yeah. But that is definitely secondary to, you know, people who want to join this program to enrich their lives and enrich the lives of their families.
Yep.
So, Julian, someone wants to know, and that would be at 8 p.m. I think we said 8. Yeah.
On Sunday?
Yeah, I'm not sure. Or earlier?
We'll send it out. It's earlier. Because that's the
deal. That's right. Yeah, so it'll probably be like 5 or 6 p.m. Eastern time on Sunday. But we'll send it out to you guys. So, Julian, someone wants to know, as a recent college graduate, would I qualify to even begin this investment?
There's no age whatsoever. You're going to have to show some income. Because you were in college, they may not have the 2-3 year income requirement because you're in college, depending on what your income is out of college. Right. You getting this knowledge early. I wish I had this knowledge early at college. I'd only read Rich Dad Poor Dad. But to have somebody like me, actually take me by under their wing and actually guide me, my portfolio would probably be over 100 doors by now if I had that extra 10-year head start. So getting this information, this is really big for you because typically we don't invest in ourselves. You know, K-12, other people are pouring into our heads. College, we just go there because we're supposed to. For you to pull money out of your own pocket and say, I know something, I know I didn't learn something that I need to know, and I'm actually going to commit to it myself. That's going to be huge for you in terms of just the trajectory of your life, is investing in yourself. I'm excited to see a college student here, because guess what? Watch this. How many elders, meaning that you're older than a college student, how many elders wish you would have known this at the age of 22? How many elders wish you would have known this at the age of 22? See? So you're about to get something that most people regret not knowing. And it's no fault to the elders here, myself included. We just didn't know. So the fact that you're here, something has brought you here at this moment in time. And you're seeing that everybody who is older than you says that they wish they would have known it when they were you. So you want to take advantage of this.
All right. So Labricia asks, I am active duty, so I can only join part-time for now. She has 5 years until retirement. Could I do this without being in the area that I want to invest in?
Yeah. Remember, I bought my second and third property without actually being there. And I bought more properties in New Orleans. I brought 2 through 5 without actually even being in New Orleans, right? So, So I'm going to show you how to invest from a distance. It's going to require a great team on the ground wherever you are, wherever you do decide to invest. But I'm going to show you how to do that.
All right. So Denise wants to know, can I use my 401k to get started?
No, you cannot use your 401k. You'd have to transfer that to our IRA, and you'd have to transfer it to an IRA. So there's some trickery. The 401k, 401k is one of those other, it's one of those other traps. It will work for past generations. It does not, it actually traps you. Because you cannot invest in real estate through your 401k. You can do it from a self-directed IRA, but not through a 401k. So this is part of the trickery. And we just go in and we sign these papers and we don't really know what's happening. So there's different ways to work it out though.
All right. So Brad states, I live in California. What if you have a 750 credit score, 40K in cash, 40K in business credit, currently in short-term disability? Will you help evaluate commercial property deals? My main goal is to acquire 5 or more units out of state.
So I have to say no, unfortunately. I don't have any commercial yet. And that's a completely different type of loan. With 40,000 collateral and 80,000 in business credit, that's probably not enough to acquire a commercial property. But you're gonna have to talk to a commercial lender. I'm staying in my lane. I'm not gonna pretend like I have it all figured out. I know where my zone of genius is, and right now it's in multifamily real estate. So I don't want to lead you astray. You may want to find another mentor for that. But if you're trying to get a 2-4 family home with that credit profile, I know I can help you.
Jack wants to know, can a couple join under one membership?
Yes. So a couple can join under one membership. And the way that that works is you will share one login. You probably know each other's, logins anyway. And you'll go through, and then once you're in, you will email my, my assistant and let her know, that you are joining, who your significant other is, and your significant other will be put on the email, reminders and things of that nature. And you will go through the program together.
All right. Yeah. Yeah. So what do you call it? The three B's, Julian?
Oh yeah. Three B's. Your
bloodline, business partners, and what's the other one?
Best friend.
That's right.
Yeah. Bloodline, business partner, best friend. That has to be the criteria.
All right. Kat, thank you for the reminder. I forgot that next Monday is actually Labor Day. So everything will actually be closed. So you may not actually be paid on the 1st or the 2nd. So, you know, if you send that email, we'll extend it to the 3rd because we know it's a holiday. But I forgot.
It's all good.
All right. All right. Should a married couple buy houses individually to scale up past the 10 house max quicker?
Heck yes. But if you're filing taxes together, when they ask for your taxes, it's going to be both of you. So in order to do that, you could get to 20 if you file separately. So there is some cost of filing separately. You might not get all the tax breaks as a couple gets, but if you're going to create more wealth by having a real estate portfolio that is growing faster than what you would save, then yes, you could get up to 20 homes that way separately, as opposed to having 10 as a unit.
All right. So Denise wants to know, how can we vet this program before purchasing? Do you have reviews we can access or we can contact from your former students?
I read two of them. This program is new. So those are people that I guided personally through the process, and I've downloaded the process that I guided them through to create this for you. So those are the two people I've guided through this process thus far. So it's a new program. We will have tons of testimonials soon, but that's what we have right now. Forget the testimonials. I'm sitting right in front of you. I've acquired 10 multifamily. How many people do you know in your personal network or in your phone right now that you can call that have acquired 10 multifamily homes? How many do you know that have acquired 3? How many do you know that have acquired 2 or even 1? I'm going to be your guide and your advisor on this journey. So I'm the living proof. And then I've shown that not only can I do it for myself, I can do it for other people. So that is all I have to prove to you right now is my own story and the stories of these two families. That's what I have.
Yeah. And also when it comes to vetting, and I definitely understand the need to do that. Don't forget that you have a 30-day money back guarantee. Right. No questions asked, right? So you have 30 days to vet this program, to actually see if it is if it's for you or not. Mm-hmm. All right. I think so. All right, Vanita wants to know, so if monthly information is dripped to you, how does that look? What information do you get each month?
It's weekly. It's weekly. I just want to be clear that it's weekly.
Right.
And it's a new challenge every single week. It's a new challenge. I'm not sure what else. I talked about each challenge in the webinar. So I'm not sure what additional Danita needs.
All right. Yeah. So just to explain that piece of the program, yes, you are getting a new module every single week. As a reminder, there are 12 different modules associated with this particular course. So each week you will get a new one, right? That's going to be dripped to you along with a challenge to go along with it. And then on Sunday nights, as you're going through this process, that's the time for you to answer or to ask your questions in the deal room calls with Julian, which you sign up for beforehand as well. So someone wants to know, do I need a real estate license to be a real estate investor?
No, man. These myths are out there. No, not at all. I don't have a license. I don't have a license, y'all. I don't have a license. No, you just have to have this knowledge. Intellectual property will get you physical property. All right. So, yeah, no, you do not.
All right. Let's see, will you also be teaching us? Okay, yeah, so Lee wants to know, will you also be teaching us about the different real estate laws in different states?
No, I only know three markets. I don't even know the entire state of Louisiana or California. No. I know three markets, and there's not too many laws you need to know. You need to know the Airbnb laws in your city if you're going to leverage short-term rentals, but there's not too many laws that you need to know to navigate this space. Many of the laws, if you're talking about trying to build on an extra unit and things of that nature from permits that your contractors have to know the laws. But besides that, you don't, and your contractors and your agents, they know the laws. That's what you hire them for. That's what they get paid for. And they operate within those guidelines. It's not a law school course.
All right. All right, so let's congratulate a few more people who just signed up. So congratulations to Paula. Congratulations to Roy. Donna, I see you in chat too. So congratulations, Desiree, Emmanuel. I can't remember if I mentioned Vanita or not a little while ago. But congratulations, you know, to all of you guys for signing up. You know, we're very happy to have you a part of the program. Yes, and yeah, thank you for believing and trusting in us as you go through this real estate journey. Mm-hmm. All right, Julian, we'll take a couple more questions. I think we can go ahead and wrap up for the night.
Yeah, two more.
All right. So will you guys instruct how to effectively manage the number of doors after you acquire them or recommend a property manager?
Probably won't be able to recommend a property manager because you're in your own market, but I'll show you how to choose your property manager. Yes, yes. I don't know property managers in every single market, so I can't recommend one. And there are not a lot of national property management companies, so it's not like I can just recommend a national company that you could choose from. So that's going to be a local search, and you'll meet those people through relationships. It may be your real estate agent. Your real estate agent may be your property manager. So I'll show you how to vet them.
All right. Let's see. So Anonymous asks, if I'm in the process of saving toward a down payment, but have not yet saved enough, can I still participate in the coursework in the program?
Yes. Remember, you want to do the coursework simultaneously while you're getting the other three things together, your income, your down payment, and your credit, so that the moment that those three things are in place, you can actually start making offers, right? You don't want to wait to do all those things first and then have to take another 12 weeks to learn, right? So you want to do those things simultaneously. Okay, I'm doing the third step, which is actually training your eye. You can get finance. You can have the finance in the line, but guess what? Just because you're finance doesn't mean you can know how to find the deal. My expertise is helping you actually find the deal and position yourself to win it, okay?
All right, so this will be the last question for tonight, everybody. And if I did not get to answer your question, I'm truly sorry about that. We've had probably close to 150 questions that came in. So there's no way that we can answer every single question that is out there, but we will have a special Q&A call on Sunday night, right? So on Sunday night, this Sunday night, we'll have a special Q&A call to answer more questions specifically related to the offer that we presented about the Black Real Estate Investor Group, right? So if you have questions about coaching and having, you know, very specific questions, you know, to you, we probably won't be able to get to those types of questions. But if you are on the fence about joining the program and you know, need some, you know, assurances or you need some, you know, just clarifications as it relates to, you know, your situation for that, then yes, please come to the Q&A call on Sunday night. I'm not exactly sure what time that is. It'll probably be either 5 or 6 p.m.
5 Central.
So 5 Central, 6 p.m. Eastern. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it'll be 6 p.m. Eastern on Sunday night. So please make sure you come out to that. There will be a Zoom link similar to this link that will be sent out for that particular call. All right, so Lakeisha asked, we'll answer Lakeisha's question, Julian, then you can go ahead and wrap us up. Lakeisha asked, what about the Black Real Estate Investor Group? That's free. Is the Facebook group free as well?
That's free. You know the answer?
Yeah, so I think this is a good time to actually go over the offer again. So the multifamily course that Julian was talking about, that becomes free or when you join the Black Real Estate Investor Group.
Right.
Right. Yeah. So, and that is one of two options. There's no lifetime option. There's one of two options. It's either $299 per month or $2,499 per year. No lifetime option on the Black Real Estate Investor Group. When you join that, you do get access to the Facebook pay or the Facebook group. But you have to be a member of the Black Real Estate Investor Group to get access to that Facebook group as well. That's where Julian, you know, answers your specific questions. In addition to the deal room calls, he answers your specific questions related to your situation, right? In terms of just getting real estate. Yeah. So that is, you know, what we're offering here.
Boom.
All right, everybody. Well,
Man, I just want to say I'm grateful for each one of you being here. I mean, literally, we're on a Saturday night. We're going towards 11 o'clock. And so that's how I know we know you're really serious about this and you really want this in your life. And I just know that I can help accelerate the process for you, make sure you don't make any costly mistakes on this journey. And that's my commitment. I'm channeling the spirit of Harriet Tubman, and I'm seeking to free 300 people and families through this process. And I've tried many different roads, and this has been one of the most proven ones. And so I would love to take you on the journey with me if you're ready to go. So you got till Sunday to make a decision. I encourage you to make it by Sunday, probably Saturday night, so that you can go through orientation on Sunday morning and be ready for our Sunday night weekly deal room call. I don't want you to have to wait another week for that to come through. So go ahead, make the decision, sleep on it, pray on it, do what you got to do, but make that decision by Saturday night. And I can't wait to serve you.
All right, man. I have nothing else to say.
Cool.
So other than thank you for believing in us and trusting in us. And like Julian said, being here on a Sunday night.
Saturday night. No, Friday night.
Or Friday night.
There it is.
Friday night.
Okay, we'll see you Sunday night, though, if you have additional questions, all right? Because there's hundreds of questions that we're going to try to pound through those on Sunday.
All right, then. So
much love.
All right. Good night.
Peace.